Get ready for a big football game today as the Orange take the field against the South Florida Bulls, who are trying to end a three-game losing streak. This is Big East Football, and we kick it off next. It is a cold, wet, dank day here in Central New York, but inside the Carrier Dome, nice and warm for an afternoon of football as the South Florida Bulls and the Syracuse Orange get together. Somebody's going to leave last place here in the Big East Conference. Welcome inside as the Syracuse Orange are making their way onto the field for this home game. It's family weekend. Glad you could join us, everybody. Dave Sims along with John Kinjemi in the Syracuse quarterback situation in a state of flux. Andrew Robinson got hurt last week. Cameron Dantley got the play in the second half. Dantley may get his first start today. We still may see Robinson.
Yeah, Robinson hasn't been able to do much this week, Dave. And in pregame warmups, he was able to come out, throw the football. Now, last week in the first half against the Panthers, only 4 of 9 for 46 yards, and he was sacked twice. But if it is Cameron Dantley, he'll be making his first collegiate start today and have an opportunity to move the offense. He has a cannon of a right arm, has a lot of poise, and has a tremendous upside. But, Dave, the problem with any quarterback playing for the Orange today is, can that offensive line keep them on their feet, and can they provide any quarterback with a running game? That'll be the key for either one of those
Syracuse
guys.
Is last in rushing in the Big East Conference, and compounding that, whoever plays at quarterback has to go against one of the nation's top defenders, George Selvey. He only leads the country in tackles for losses and sacks.
He's a true playmaker on the edge for the Bulls. He can make plays with his legs. He's so athletic. He's got a speed rush to the outside and has a lot of power. Now, last week against the Panthers, this Orange offensive line let up 6 sacks and 37 on the year, which ranks last in the Big East Conference. If the Orange continue to have trouble running the football, Salvi and company will bring the heat early and often.
George Selvey and the South Florida Bulls trying to end a three-game losing streak. A win today guarantees them a bowl game as we get ready for the third meeting between these two clubs. South Florida's won the first two games, and coming up in the program, we're going to get to know George Selvey just a little bit better. A fun young man. Kinjemi's Gems, a lot of interesting things happening in the Big East Conference. And Zonk, Larry Zonk, one of the all-time greats of all football, he'll be by to have a conversation here on Big East Football from Syracuse, New York. Today's ESPN Plus game is brought to you by Pontiac, official performance machines of the NCAA. Allstate, proud sponsors of college football. Are you in good hands? PNC leading the way. The all-new Ranger RZR. See it up close at your local Polaris Ranger dealer. Verizon Wireless. Principal Financial Group will give you an edge. Yamaha ATVs, ain't nothing tougher than a Yamaha. And by Suzuki, maker of performance-driven motorcycles, scooters, and all-terrain vehicles. Syracuse Ben, entertaining earlier here on campus, inside the Carrier Dome. Big East football about to kick it off, and let's get more on South Florida. Third member of our broadcast crew, Sarah Kusta.
Dave, John, just 3 weeks ago, this South Florida team ranked number 2 in the nation. 3 straight losses, though, and this Bulls team is absent from the polls. The coaches reminded their team, though, that this has not dismantled their goals. Head coach Jim Leavitt said it's human nature to be down after this, but we as coaches have to mentally get them going. With a win today, USF can become bowl guaranteed. Winning out on the season would place the team with the most victories in USF history. Dave, getting to number 2 doesn't change the focus to still build this program.
And this program too, Sarah, they're trying to rebound from 3 losses. Last week, a crushing loss, 38-33. They gave up 31 first quarter points and had a chance to win the game on the last play. Here's Justin Tichy kicking it up and down the sideline, running up to get it is Max Suter. Fumble, loose ball, far side. South Florida's recovered. So a terrible start for Syracuse here at home on Family Day. South Florida's going to have the ball at the 25-yard line.
Well, Dave, special teams for the Orange continue to be a problem. Last week against the Panthers, they gave the Panthers excellent field position inside the 30-yard line numerous occasions. And now to start the game, it looks like Suter has a problem with the opening kickoff, and the Bulls are going to get excellent field position
inside the 30.
Suter had it, dropped it, and there's some issues now.
Yeah, just couldn't get on it. A lot of bodies on the ground. Suter coming in, and it's always tough running in, getting those last couple steps. You see a lot of people on the ground fighting for the football, but the Bulls have it with great field position.
Dylan Douglas recovered. Here's Matt Grothy in the offense. Real quick bubble screen outside, and almost breaking is Carlton Mitchell. What an athlete he is. 6'4", 197, a freshman from Lux, Florida. Now their quarterback, Matt Grothy, is having a great year. Fourth in the Big East in rushing. He is seventh in passing efficiency, second in total offense to Brown.
Well, this is a guy that can beat you with his arm and with his legs. The only problem the last couple weeks, he's been giving it too much to the other team. He has to cut down on the interception and fumbles.
Syracuse has had all kinds of problems with turnovers as they run up the middle. Big running room at the 15 to the 10. Bouncing to his right, struggling to the 4-yard line. It'll be a first and goal for Mike Ford. He picks up 20 yards on the run. Mike Ford, number three rusher on the ball club behind Grothy and Williams.
Terrific blocking and a good patience by Mike Ford. He had a rib issue last week. He was a game time decision. This week, no issue on his first carry, north and south inside the 5-yard line.
Grothy and company got to cash in. A turnover on the first play of the game. Straight up the gut. Not in, but close. Grothy with the keeper.
And Dave, maybe Jake Griffin, the center, the junior out of Sefner, Florida, may be down for the Bulls.
Nick Capone, senior from Clearwater, may be his replacement. He's number 69. Jake Griffin, number 77.
That's what you get from Grothy. When you use that spread offense, you have that extra blocker in the backfield, and when you spread the offense out by formation, it opens up the quarterback run for Matt Grothy.
46 red zone possessions, 25 TDs, 10 field goals for South Florida. Touchdown percentage 54%. And the turnover story, we talked about that. 12 turnovers for the Orange have led to 66 points for their opponents. 8 touchdowns and a field goal. Grothy, a dynamic performer at quarterback position. Balls inside the one to Pona as they wait for Griffin to get off the field. There you go with the wishbone. Give it the Ford right side. Walks in almost untouched. South Florida 6-0. Right off the get-go. Very little resistance on the right side. Touchdown South Florida.
Boy, great job, Dave, on the right side of that line. Zach Herman, Mark Dial, the fullback Kelly. Just a terrific surge on the line of scrimmage, and it's a bad break for Syracuse opening up, but watch the surge. They seal there, and it just nobody touches Mike Ford.
So they waste no time. Here's Alvarado for the point after. And it's up and good. So we've played 80 seconds, and South Florida has a 7-0 lead here at Syracuse. Big East football. Mike Ford, boy, he could have tiptoed in on that one. 7-0 South Florida. Well, Mike Ford feeling pretty good as he caps off a 4-play, 26-yard drive and 120. As the South Florida Bulls capitalize on the Suter fumble on the opening kickoff, South Florida deferred. And Max will get a chance to do it again. He needs just 48 yards to tie the Big East record set by Will Blackman back in 2003. This time he has to retreat, and he'll take it a yard deep. 10-15. Got a TD against Louisville, and he gets straightened up, breaks a tackle, and fights his way to the 20-yard line, brought down by Sabbath Joseph, a 20-yard return. So now we get a look to see who will be the quarterback. It will be Cameron Dantley, son of basketball star and should be Hall of Famer Adrian Dantley, now assistant coach with the Denver Nuggets. Outstanding performance last week. He made two really good throws last week for touchdowns.
Boy, didn't he?
A fade and a deep post where he just gunned it in on the post, ignoring the fact that the cornerback had a pretty good look at it. A swing pass, and that one, one hop, that's intended for Doug Hogue. the running game, John, has hard to believe we're at Syracuse. We're talking about a running game that's almost non-existent. Just four rushing touchdowns, 69 yards a game. And last week, the Orange rushed 31 times for 30 yards.
Well, teams with consistency, at some point, you have to be able to run the football. And that takes a lot of pressure off your quarterback. And I don't care if you have a veteran quarterback or a guy making his first start, as in Cameron Dantley.
Dantley out of Silver Spring, Maryland. Hands off to Hogue. Hogue for about four off the left guard. Take a look at our starting lineups, brought to you by Suzuki Motorcycles. Doug Hogue, he's playing, he's starting because Brinkley's out. DeLon Carter's out for the season with injuries. Mike Williams and Taj Smith are having a great season catching the ball. The offensive line, they got some work to do. Corey Chavers is going to be called on today to try to stop George Selby. They call this their pistol formation, not the shotgun. Only a couple steps behind the center. Dantley looking, checking down. Boy, he does have a good arm. First down. Boy, he zipped that into Mike Williams. Mike Williams comes into this game, his last two contests, 15 catches for 194 yards and two touchdowns, a pickup of 11.
Dantley did a great job. He's looking left the entire side, didn't like what he saw to the outside, and had the presence of mind of coming back. He knew he had a curl in the middle of the football field to one of his playmakers, Mike Williams, and what a drill shot that was.
John, remember yesterday when we spoke to Brian White, the offensive coordinator, he says he's got an unbelievable arm. It's all about the footwork. If he gets his feet together, he's going to be fine.
Yeah.
Dantley waiting, looking downfield. Got a man there. 40, 35. Smith on his feet. Fights his way inside the 30. Big play for Syracuse. Boy, did they need that. A gain of 37 yards. Taj Smith has been hot, too. His last two games, 9 catches. 222 yards and a touchdown.
Well, this is a quarterback that's making his first start. You're going to see the cornerback level off here, and the wide receiver is just going to run a fade route by him. Watch the level off of the cornerback. He's going to stay there, run right by him, and get in that soft spot between the corner and the safety. The safety's still on the hash. Dantley makes an awesome read and a better throw.
How about Smith with the yards after the catch? Picked up another 12. First down, toss play, left side hold. Penalty flag on a play, gain of about 3. The penalty coming up. Referee today is Gerard McGinn. Umpires Michael Sucheski, linesman's Matt Fitzgerald. Todd Reese is the line judge. Patrick Garvey's the side judge. The field judge is Jim Downey. The back judge, Keith Washington, and Charles Phillips, the replay official.
Number 69, 15-yard penalty from the previous line of scrimmage. Replay, first down.
Major penalty on Larry Norton, a chop block.
Yeah, Aaron Harris really got chopped on the play, and that's going to really limit what they can do defensively, especially on that front. Claybert had an ankle injury going into the UConn, or got it in the UConn game going into the Cincinnati game last week. Alan Cray, his backup, has been limited with an ankle. So, you know, in that position, that defensive line is going to be hampered by injuries.
Woody George getting a start at defensive end. We'll run down those starters in a moment. Going far side is Mike Williams. Tight end, bottom of your screen is J.J. Neshwa.
Well, I mean, nice time to take a shot here.
Tell you what, one of the great matchups today, the Syracuse wide receivers were pretty formidable. Williams and Smith going against great corners, Trey Williams and Mike Jenkins. Greg Robinson's club down by a touchdown. Jenkins, 5 career interceptions. Here's Robinson as they converse with Brian White, the offensive coordinator. Cleavert, Harris, they man the middle. Selby, we told you about him. Woody George getting the start, beating out Jared Bowie. The linebackers all quick. Ben Moffitt, the leader, team leader as well. Got 3 interceptions and a touchdown return. The corners are brilliant. They're going to play on Sundays. Williams and Jenkins. And Allen and Williams are not shabby either.
Carlton Williams, he loves playing close to that line of scrimmage. And I think he's a better player the closer he gets to the line of scrimmage. And that defensive coordinator, Wally Burnham, he's the guy that makes it tick on defense. He's very aggressive. Just one of those throwback coaches. You love sitting down and talking X's and O's with Wally.
First down and halfway to Buffalo here for the Syracuse Orange. First and 25. Ball's at the 43 after that chop block penalty. starting right tackle Larry Norton. They go three wide, top of your screen. High snap, blown up immediately by George Selver. Brian Kelly, Cincinnati coach, told us he's a great second effort player. Well, that was an easy first effort play. The sophomore for Pensacola, loss of three.
Yeah, right away, Dave. Make it 28.5 tackles for a loss. Salvi just reads the play entirely. It was set up for him with the bad snap from center, but George Salvi, just an athlete on the edge. You have to account for where he is at all times, because just a crease and Salvi will make a play behind the line of scrimmage.
Another step or two, he could have taken the handoff.
Yeah.
Second and 28. 37-yard play. Now they're trying to get back to ground zero, and Hogue gets slammed down. Bruce Montfumeir, and you can hear the restless fans here. They know the running game is almost null and void. And Dantley does have a live arm. They want to see the football in the air.
Well, just a couple plays ago, Syracuse was rolling and they were relying on their receivers. And that's the key to the game on the side, for the keys to the game, the principal keys to the game. Tosh Smith and Mike Williams have to make plays on the outside, and they're going against two of the best corners in the league in Williams and Jenkins.
Good look at our principal financial group edge to today's game. Third and 25. Here comes Selby. Look out, and he's got him. Boy, he blew right by Tucker Bumbach. It was no contest. Absolutely no contest. Loss of four. Sack for Selvig.
That, Dave, this is just pure speed to the outside. Bombeck had no chance of getting in front of George Salvi. Couldn't move his feet quick enough to get in front of George on the play and add another sack to that sack leader, the nation leader in sacks.
14 and a half. Boy, that was stealing. Rob Long to punt. Hangs one up, beautiful. Nicely done. Fair catch signal. They didn't signal fair catch. We've been through this before, back in the Connecticut game. 4-6 on the hang time, a 44-yard punt. Connecticut did that, and the young man got away with it, scored a touchdown, and it helped Connecticut come from behind to beat Louisville. They throw a flag on that?
I don't see one down there, but it looked like he definitely waved.
There's no question. Wait, there's no getting around that.
We weren't the only ones that saw it, Dave.
Larry gave a fair catch signal. The whistle was blown before the receiver took off. First down, South Florida.
He catches a break. He catches a break by a nanosecond.
First of all, I'm not sure what Murphy's doing catching the football inside the 10-yard line. You know, rule number one, if you start on the 10, and if your feet go backwards, don't catch the football.
Tried a little trickery. Didn't quite work. 7-0 South Florida.
How about that?
Good look at Krause College, the musical headquarters of Syracuse University. Cloudy day, folks at South Florida, even the radio guys, the radio producer came in and said, boy, I'm glad we're playing inside today. It's 37 degrees, windy, cold, a little wet. Here's Grothy, far side, trying to get Williams and Mitchell in space, and he makes something out of it. Picks up about six on the plays. We take a look at the starting lineups brought to you by Suzuki Motorcycles. A lot of speed here. Mitchell, Jesse Hester Jr., very dependable. Cedric Hills, a speedy tight end at 6'3", 230. Offensive line, not as good as it was last year, but they provide enough talent and time for Matt Grothy to throw the football. And a second down and five at the 10-yard line. Grothy on a keeper, first down and more. 20, 25, 26-yard line. First down for South Florida. Joe Fields brings him down. Joe, the top tackler on the Syracuse ball club, a 16-yard pickup.
Yeah, and Joe's doing a better job of tackling in the open field. He's getting more and more experience moving from quarterback to free safety. But when you spread out by formation, it sets up the quarterback run because it gives you an extra blocker with your running back. And Matt Grothy is a terrific and dynamic open field runner.
Double wides both sides. Torres Johnson in the game. Grothy throwing over the middle, wide open, bobbled and then caught, first down yardage to Carlton Mitchell. Mitchell with another catch. That's a gain of 11 for Syracuse. Their offense rated last in the Big East Conference. Gilbo, Jones, Santiago, and McLean. McLean's second team all Big East a year ago. Parker Canty getting a start. He'll come out nickel situation. Stendling, his second start. Good secondary. Davis back at safety. Holmes has been performing well at corner. First down, South Florida, 38-yard line. What a difference a year makes. A difference a week makes. Last week, South Florida gave up 31 first quarter points. Fumble. And they're going to say it was down. Mike Ford on to Kerry McLean, recovered, but the whistle is blown. And now we got another injured South Florida player, Mark Dial.
See, if he was down here, Mike Ford had a little bit of a crease. It looked like the legs of Mark Dial were caught up from behind. You can see the legs come right out from underneath him. Ford was definitely down, but watch, there's the injury right there.
Oh, God.
From the back end. His legs came right underneath him.
That's a tough one. McLean last year, big numbers. Number four tackler on the team, led the club in tackles for loss.
And
Mark
Dave,
Dial is a junior Miami. This is big.
This is really big because Dial went from left tackle to right tackle, replacing Walter Walker about 3 weeks ago, who was their dynamic player up front. And if you lose Mark Dial, you're into your third tackle.
Already see Jake Griffin. And they're going to get Mark Dial up. They already suffered an injury to Jake Griffin, the starting center. That was in the first couple of plays. Although Jake Griffin is back, so that's good to see. Number 77 is Dial.
Well, we
take a look at our principal financial group edge to the game.
Yeah, Dave, we talked about holding on to the rock, and that time Mike Ford was called down. But South Florida has been able to take the football away defensively, but offensively they're giving it right back. Eight turnovers last week against Cincinnati, and they still had a chance to win at the end. But they have to take care of the football today.
Amazing. This team was number two in the country 4 weeks ago. Three games in a row. Both on a keeper, big running room. He's close to a first down. In fact, he has the first down. Joe Fields making the tackle. This spread offense were run by Grothy. Grothy's very fast. Not as lightning fast as Patrick White, but he's so effective.
Well, this is a guy that can make plays with his legs, and he's a pretty good thrower. The only problem is he gets tired at the end of games after running the first, second, and third quarter. And today, in a controlled environment, I don't think that'll be an issue.
Made that point last week, and it was a darn good one too. As we got later into that game, it was a 4-hour, 15-minute game and lost to Cincinnati. Nice job by Jake Flaherty, the middle linebacker. About a yard gain that time, and a run by Ford. Take a look at our game-changing performer brought to you by Pontiac, and it is the aforementioned Matt Grothy.
Well, he leads the team in rushing. He's done a pretty good job in throwing the football. He has to protect it a little bit better through the air, but you know, came into the game with 625 yards. That's a school record in leading his team in rushing, so doing a great job on the ground.
He's rushed for more yardage this year than a guy named Michael Vick did during his time at Virginia Tech when they were in the Big East Conference. Could be a face mask coming up. Could have been. They may have gotten away with one. Carlton Mitchell makes the catch. Gain of 13. Three rushes for 26 yards for Matt Grothy today. And Mitchell having a good day.
Dave, this is too easy of a read for Matt Grothy. The linebacker's going to drop back and then leave the middle of the field. And that leaves that curl route wide open right here. There's nobody in the middle of the field for Grothy to read.
Grothy in a rollout. Chased by McLean. That's thrown out of bounds. Boy, hit the tight end underneath.
Busby.
Yeah. Wide open running an outback.
Good pressure that time by Jameel McLean on the edge. He read the bootleg all the way, and I think that was the reason why Grothy couldn't set his feet square up and find his tight end.
Busby was running free and clear, running it out to the far sideline.
May want to come back to that route, you know, in a couple plays and get Grothy on the edge, give him another chance to find his big tight end.
That'll go three wide to the bottom of your screen. Grothy 4 for 5. They run a blitz. Ford for about a yard, 2 yards tops. Grothy 4 or 5, 32 yards passing this far. Arthur Jones making the stop for Syracuse. Glad you could join us, everybody. Big East football from Syracuse, New York. It's family weekend here at the Carrier Dome. Along with John Congemi and Syracuse.com, I'm Dave Sims. Glad you could join us. Cloudy, cold day here in Syracuse. Inside the dome, no problem. South South Florida has a 7-0 lead. The opening kickoff was fumbled by Syracuse. South Florida converted it, a 4-play, 26-yard drive, 4-to-1-yard run.
Dave, if I'm Grothy, I look for that curl route again.
That play blown dead.
Prior to snap, false start on the offense. Number 65, 5-yard penalty remains. Third down.
Ryan Schmidt called for that infraction. First play of the game, folks. The opening kickoff. Max Suter, who has a TD coast to coast against Louisville for a touchdown. Fumbled it. Mike Ford cashed it in. 7-0. That's where we are right now. Grothy's going to go empty backfield. He's got 12 seconds on a play clock. He's got a 3rd and 13 at the Syracuse 39. 6 in a box for the Orange. Grothy play change with 4 on the play clock. They get it off. Got time. Throwing behind his receiver. Incomplete. They've changed a few numbers here, John, since we saw these guys last. So we saw them just a week ago.
Well, Grothy tries to go max protection. He had a little smash route to the outside, but the ball was high and wide and well covered versus man coverage. Grothy audibles. He had the corner route run by Jesse Hester. He'll see that tomorrow on film, but he decided to go underneath, and the ball was high and outside.
That was Carlton Hill, a backup quarterback. Here's the punt. High hanger. And Jeff get inside the 10. They do. It's fair caught at the 9 by Ryan Howard. A 31-yard punt. Good job on the punt by Alvarado. 4-1 on the hang time. 7-0 South Florida. With a 7-0 lead. First quarter here at Syracuse. Just under 5 to play. Mike Ford, a 1-yard run. The only score for the Bulls and in this ballgame. Here's Dantley's numbers to this point. Get a live arm. Sprint out. He's got time. And downfield. Nice catch. And a comebacker. Gets it to Mike Williams. Lively arm, John.
Boy, big time arm. And he was looking. He was waiting for Williams to get out of that route and throw it on the sideline. Just a good outside route. Watch Dantley. He's going to drift to his right a little bit. Make the little bit easier of a throw. Shuffling in the pocket. Good protection that time offensively by the line. And a good shot to the outside. Just a little sidearm sling to the outside to Mike Williams.
16 yards. Seven nothing South Florida. Play fake selfie, jailbreak, penalty flag. Dantley gets out and he's taken out by the linebacker Tyrone McKenzie. A 5-yard run. Penalty flags all over. George Selvey got in there. It looked like he was in a holding.
On the offense, number 73, 10-yard penalty from the previous line of scrimmage. Replay, first down.
Jonathan Meldrum. It looks like Selvey's coming out of starting blocks at the Big East.
Yeah, he could have run. He could have run 100 yards, meters, no problem. Selvey's the top of your screen. He's going to come in from the edge. And inside, too, there's a big-time hold there on 94, Alan Cray. So you can take your pick on the edge. You also had Woody George coming from the other side. So those guys, we talked about it in the open. If this offensive line doesn't protect in the supporting cast, those guys on the front four for the Bulls are going to pin their ears back and come.
And then you got the two corners who are great press
guys.
Lock
it down, yeah.
Right. So, I mean, if South Florida can get pressure with four, they're going to be in the driver's seat for a long time here today. First and 20 at the 15. They rush fourth, and the timing got thrown off there.
Prior to snap, false start on the offense. Number 77, 5-yard penalty remains. First down.
Well, if you're going against George Selvey and he was beating you to the punch every time, you'd raise up a little bit early, too. 3 penalties, 30 yards.
Dave, we talked about it before the game started privately. You know, Syracuse will have one or two positive plays like they did on the big pass play here in the first series. Then they get a penalty. Now they're in third and long situations. This year in third and long, they've been miserable. They haven't been able to convert with any consistency, so it's a problem for this offense.
You got a tight end to chip against Selvey on this play. Half roll, fake, Big arm, he got popped. What a throw! But incomplete on a flyer to Mike Williams. I tell you what, Richard Kleber brought the house down on Cam Dantley.
Takes courage, Dave, to stay in that pocket when you know Kleber's coming at you. Salvi goes to the inside, little twist with Kleber. He gets run over by his own player. Good block by Nejwat, the tight end who ended up staying in there. But there's the big time hit. He was still able to throw that 50, 60 yards on
the line. I tell you what, Richard Kleber, D linemen dream of shots like that.
Yeah. I don't like their dreams, by the way, Dave.
Well, you're not in them, so you're okay. Caught from behind, tackle for a loss. Who was it? You bet, Selvey. Hogan, nowhere to go. Selvey is putting on a clinic, loss of two. But it's his own little playground, and we're just watching.
Yeah, he's in charge of the sandbox today, Dave, and he's going to run everything that's inside the tackles, outside the tackles. It's his playground today. Salvi just runs down the line of scrimmage. He looks like a defensive back running, but he's such an elusive guy. You have to account with your tackle and your running back when you're pass protecting, but when you're run protecting, he's coming from the backside making plays.
Syracuse 0 for 18 on third and at least 15 this season. They're 0 for 18. Goodness gracious. Here's a quick kick, and he just got it off. Penalty flag, and they're going to maybe get some positive out of this one as Alan Craig, John Barker, who's their all-time, you know, they're a really good utility guy, holds quick kicks, does all kinds of interesting things. Let's see what we have.
Personal foul. Rough of the kicker. On the defense. And 7-6. 15-yard penalty. Automatic. First down.
Where did Syracuse get a break there? So now they've converted. They're 1 of 19 on third and at least 15 on the season. Catch a break.
Dave, I'm not sure. I mean, he's outside of the pocket. I know this is a quick kick. You know, you give the interpretation that he may have got a piece of this. He didn't get a piece of it. It was wide right of, it looked like 96, Woody George, or no, 94, Alan Gray.
He was blocked into him.
He was blocked into him, number one. It was third down on a quick kick, number two, and he's outside.
Outside the tackle box?
Yeah. I think, if anything, McKenzie blocks Gray into the quick kick.
And Syracuse has a new life. First and 10 now. It's own 22. Latter stages now, first quarter, 7-0. Mike Ford, 1 yard run. Four receivers left side, left tackle moved too soon. They'll let him play over the middle. No. Try to get it. Selvey was the one that was putting pressure. Dan Sheeran, redshirt freshman, the intended receiver.
Offsides on the defense. Number 95. 5-yard penalty remains. First down.
Well, it's our pleasure to welcome in one of the great coaches in the Big East and in the country, Rich Rodriguez, head coach of the West Virginia Mountaineers, coming off a win the other night against Louisville. Hey, Rich, thanks for joining us. And, give us your impressions on your win the other day.
Well, we were obviously happy to get the win, and I told the team afterwards I'd rather win pretty than lose ugly. And, you know, at times it was certainly ugly, but our guys hung in there and got a good win against a very talented team.
Well, Patrick had a big night. You know, he ran for 156, 10 of 16 in the air for 144. He's got to be, you know, one of your leaders on offense.
Oh, no question. And Pat was frustrated because, you know, he had that fumble late, and he very rarely drops the ball. And
right.
The first thing he told me after the game, I said, "How do you feel?" And he said, "The lead."
Yeah.
There's a bunch of us feel the same way.
Rich, he really took a shot there. I guess it was, what, late third. And was that true? He tried to run. There was an exchange of possession. He tried to run on, and defense was taking the field.
Well, I asked the trainer how ugly, and he said he's a little loopy, but he still can run fast when he's loopy, I guess. So fortunately, he came in. He just took a little shot. He's such a tough competitor. He certainly made the big play to bail us out the end.
Rich Rodriguez joining us right now, head coach of West Virginia Mountaineers. Tell me about Owen Schmidt. He was frustrated when he tried that little quick kick, and then he took the helmet and hammered himself three times in a forward. I'm sure you've seen that on tape, Coach.
No, I haven't, but I've had a lot of people tell me about that. I got to talk to Owen about that. He's got to be careful. He's such a hard-headed guy that, you know, he maybe get away with it, but I don't want him to bang himself out. I've got enough people trying to hit him, not him himself.
That's right. He and Woody Austin from the PGA have something in common. He likes to take the putter to his head. We got to tell Owen to take it easy. There's more games left for you.
Yeah, you keep your own helmet on and use somebody else's helmet again.
That's right.
Hey, who do you like today in the Connecticut Cincinnati game. It's at Cincinnati. Important game of the Big East with Connecticut riding high at 4-0.
Well, because we still got to play both of them, I'm going to take the political part and just throw a cheer for both of them. I think it's two very talented teams. It's a big game, and I think I'm sure a lot of our guys are going to be watching it today.
Well, Rich, you've been number 7 in the BCS standing since the middle of October, and it's been a good situation to be in. But there's a couple teams and a couple weeks left in the season that you guys can get some help from other teams, knocking off one-loss teams, and then take care of business, and you guys will move right up the ladder.
Well, I told him there's been a lot of people that have asked, am I concerned about our ranking? And as every coach would tell you, there's so much football to be left. There's
right.
still a lot of things that are going to happen in the next 3 weeks. And the only thing we can control is how we play. And we're trying to take it not one game at a time, one play at a time.
Well, you got some big ones. You got Cincinnati. You go to Cincinnati on the 17th. Saturday the 24th, you got Connecticut and Pittsburgh. December 1st, and he got another week off in there too, so that works out well for us.
Well, we're busy. Obviously, we got to stay healthy down the stretch. We got 2 or 3 at home, which helps, but we're going to take everybody's best shot. We got to be ready for it.
Rich, thanks for joining us. We look forward to seeing you again, and all the best. Congratulations on a great season.
Great, guys.
Thanks, Coach.
Rich Rodriguez, head coach of the West Virginia Mountaineers. But I. At Cincinnati, that's an interesting game. If Cincinnati wins today, that's a huge game.
Oh, big time. Big game because you go to Cincinnati, a place that, you know, it's not a huge stadium, but it's a great environment for the home team.
Yes, sir.
With a quality coach and a quality team playing pretty good football right now.
Third down and 12 here for the Orange. Dantley hanging, throwing short, and they get very little out of it. They go on a short crossing pattern to Mike Williams, brought down by the middle linebacker, Ben Moffitt. Now they're ticking down the final seconds of the first quarter. And we'll take a break. When we come back, Syracuse will be punting. Greg Robinson's ball club in the short end right now. Lay down a score. Mike Ford, a 1-yard run. 7-0 South Florida. Big East football from Syracuse, New York. Second quarter action coming up right after this. Welcome back, everybody. 7-0 South Florida. Second quarter about to start here at Syracuse. Andrew Robinson, injured last week. Talking with Cameron Dantley, who's starting today for the first time in his career. Redshirt junior at Silver Spring, Maryland. Here's Rob Long to punt. Spirals one down to Murphy, who watches it bounce. And it's going to be inside the 25. Punt covers 44 yards. Take a look at the ESPNU All-State Standings Review. Ohio State. You got Michigan coming up next week. Michigan's at Wisconsin today. LSU, Oregon. Oregon's, what, one fumble away from being the number one team in the country.
On the goal line.
Yeah, West Virginia in good shape.
LSU still has to play Arkansas, who's playing better football.
Georgia, number 10. They got a big one with Auburn today. That's between the hedges down in Athens, Georgia. Looks like Mark Dial is back, the right tackle. He rolled up his ankle. They bring the flanker around, and it opens up.
Wow!
Boy, did it open up! Samuels, he's gonna go! 20, 10, 5. Oh, he got to the 2-yard line. Great hustle by Dwayne Davis to hang in there. What a run! They bring the flanker around. Aston Samuels, a freshman out of Belgrade, Florida. What a jet.
Now this is real speed, Dave. This is not fast forward. Watch him turn the corner. Great block on the edge by Mike Ford. And you want to talk about effort from Syracuse? This is a great effort at the end of this play. Just leaping Dwayne Davis at the goal line. Just a terrific job. You get the ball on the 3, but terrific effort on both sides. But Samuels, what speed.
75-yard run. And knocking on the door again. Give it to Ford. Cuts inside. Second effort gets him closer. Not in yet. He did pick up about 1.5 yards. What a run by Samuels. His previous long run was 14 yards. Just 75 yards.
They wall everybody out. There's the big block on the edge by Mike Ford. You can hear pads popping. But what a great effort by Dwayne Davis. Just gets him on the 3-yard line. Just a terrific effort. Aston Samuels, just a freshman. Terrific play.
Big time. They go out of the wishbone. Big surge. Fumble. The way they're fighting in her looks like it's a fumble. Looks like South Florida's recovered. Or certainly maintained possession. Longest run of the year for South Florida. Mark Dial is back in there. Great tackle. A third down for Matt Grothian coming.
Sometimes on those quarterback sneaks, you may have to not go between the center and guard gaps. You want to inch outside between the guard and tackle and just make yourself small, get behind those big guys. But it's all about the offensive line, getting those pads low and winning the battle at the line of scrimmage.
You saw number 65, Ryan Schmidt. He was a little bit angry. See what happens here. Penalty flag. Boy, they had a good surge, too.
Prior to snap, false start. On the offense, number 65, five-yard penalty remains, third down.
We just mentioned Schmitty.
Yeah.
Right before that, he was a little fired up. He was a little bit too fired up, beat the count.
You know, strange as this sounds, this might be better for South Florida's offense to get away from the goal line, and they could spread you out and use Grothy on the edge to run the football, fake it to Mike Ford and use Grothy on the edge.
Ryan Schmidt, a transfer from Kansas State. They do spread them out, double wides, and Syracuse not ready for it. They call a timeout. They did not have personnel to match what South Florida was ready to run with.
Out of the half.
So a timeout called by Syracuse.
How big is that play by Dwayne Davis right now? Tackling Samuels on the three.
Didn't give up. And it was a great closing speed.
Yeah.
That's a nice job. Take a look at our upcoming games brought to you by Advance Auto Parts. We're ready in advance. Look at Dwayne Davis, a little bit gas, senior from the Bronx, New York, with the Columbus High School. South Florida's got Louisville left. And at Pittsburgh, Syracuse has to travel to Connecticut and Cincinnati. And Syracuse has Cincinnati still to come and the Big East standings. Congratulations to Connecticut. Who would have thunk it, right?
Yeah, 8-1 overall, 4-0 in the conference. No one guessed it.
What was the other number two? We were talking about this the other day. They got a lot of guys that got healthy from a year ago.
Well, and they redshirted guys. A lot of guys that came back.
Yeah, right.
They had the first opportunity to play, and they get a quarterback.
Makes a difference.
Yeah.
Third and goal at the six. Grothy on the draw. And penalty flags on the far side. It's not that noisy.
Fire to snap. False start. On the offense, number 78. Five-yard penalty remains. Third down.
So Mark Dial, junior from Miami, Florida, backs up Jim Leavitt's team again. Third false start today by the South Florida offense.
And Dave, it's really important for South Florida to go ahead and get into the end zone, because with the kicking problems that they have had with Delbert Alvarado inside the red zone, they've done a good job of getting to position to score, but they haven't done a good job of getting in the end zone.
Third and goal at the 11. They go five wide, three left, two right. They put a man in motion, a tight end, Cedric Hill. Grothy on a keeper, can't find anything, reverses. Can throw down field, caught, touchdown, South Florida. No flag. There's a flag late. There's a late flag as he got it to Marcus Edwards. If it stands, it'll be Marcus's first TD catch of the year.
Well, they may call offensive lineman downfield, but Nick Capona did a good job of coming back. He was actually downfield and tried to tiptoe the 10-yard line. That was a very late call. At the time of the throw, he may have been downfield.
All right.
But then he came back inside the 10-yard line.
Pass interference on the offense, number 89. 15-yard penalty from the previous line of scrimmage. Replay, third down.
This is the same kind of self-destruct mechanism that happened to South Florida when they were Connecticut a few weeks ago.
That's right. Grothy, you get the escapability of Matt Grothy. Nothing there on the run. This is a run play the whole time. He finds a wide open wide receiver on the outside in Edwards. But this play is supposed to go to the right side. He's going to wheel back around and then find his wide open wide receiver close to the end zone, but they get called by a pass interference.
You saw it was the slot man, 89, was Johnson, and he clearly impeded.
There's McClain for a sack. Grothy stays alive. And now he's just going to throw it away. Wow, he stayed alive. They had him chased back beyond the 40-yard line. Wow. He'll at least give Alvarado a reasonable shot at a field goal. Now, injured player Arthur Jones.
Arthur Jones had a hand in Matt Grothy trying to get him down, and so was Jamil McClain in hot pursuit. But Grothy was able to get out and throw the football away, and this is the escapability and the vision of Matt Grothy and the durability of trying to get him down. Grothy does all he can just to get rid of the football. He does a great job of eluding right there Jamil McClain and Geruzzi, and throws the ball in the general vicinity of Mike Ford.
How about this? South Florida had a first and goal.
On the three?
The third and goal at the one. And then backed up. A couple of penalties. 25 yards in penalties. Jones out of Endicott, New York. And let's get more on Matt Grothy. Here's Sarah Kustoff.
Dave, I think we could talk about a lot of reasons why Matt Grothy is so good. But when he speaks of himself, he said that he feels his greatest asset is his know-how expertise. I think we saw that a little bit there, but his offensive coordinator, Greg Gregory, said, Matt, he's a little bit of a riverboat gambler. He likes to take chances.
That he does, no doubt about it. Here's Alvarado, who's been spotty this year, 13 of 22. This is a 42-yard field goal. In this range, he's 4 for 8. Strikes it well, got the distance, and it's good. So Delbert Alvarado, a sophomore from Robinson High School, in Tampa, Florida, 42-yard field goal, 3 on the board for South Florida. The Bulls have a 10-0 lead.
What is tough?
Here at Syracuse, New York, Big East football this afternoon. Glad you could join us. South Florida with a 10-0 lead over the Orange. And who says every little play doesn't count? Dwayne Davis. Boy, he hauled his butt a long way from across the field, had an angle, made a diving attempt, and was able to clip the ankles of Aston Samuel. Prevented him from scoring. It would have been about a 79-yard run for a touchdown. Instead, it was a 75-yard run. It set up a field goal, so he saved him 4 points. Here's Suter. Finds a crack. Does a nice job. And swarmed under at the 31-yard line. A 27-yard return brought down by Sabbath Joseph. Second time we've called his name on special teams. He's number 43. From the Carrier Dome here in Syracuse, New York, we get to the back end of the Big East schedule. Along with John Kangemi and Sarah Kustoff, I'm Dave Sims. South Florida trying to end a 3-game losing streak in their limited history. College football only dates back 11 years. They've never lost 4 consecutive games. Greg Robinson's ball club hoping to get a lift today from Cameron Dantley in his first start. Max Suter at running back. He gets the call. Maybe back to the line of scrimmage. Tyrone McKenzie. Give him a half a yard on the game.
With a win today, Dave, it'll make a USF Bowl guaranteed for a third straight season and end that 3-game losing streak. And they've been in some games the last couple of weeks, and they've had chances to win games. They just haven't come up with big enough plays. And Jim Leavitt would love for Salvi and Harris and Kleibert and all those guys, Whitney George, to keep making plays in that defensive front.
They flopped Carroll Madison to left tackle to guard against Selvig. Throw far side, a little bit too strong, trying to get it to Mike Williams. So they move Marvin McCall to left guard. And then they move Carroll Madison. He's at left tackle.
Just a short while ago, the South Florida Bulls in their first 6 games, you can see in the 6 wins, points allowed only 15.6. In the last 3 games, teams have been lighting them up for 30 a game.
Third down and 10 for Dantley and the Orange. 9 in the box. Here they come. Look out. Jailbreak. Got rid of it, but incomplete. Tried to get it to Taj Smith. Tyrone McKenzie
among those in on Dantley, who had little or no chance. He did a heck of a job to get rid of them.
I can promise you, Dave, that's a helpless feeling for Dantley back there. You see all those white jerseys, and they're all coming right at you. You think you're running a dash the wrong way, but great strength from Cameron Dantley to slide to his right and just elude the pressure of Tyrone McKenzie to dump the football off and not take the loss.
Rob Long to punt. That was the 38th three and out this season for Syracuse. They had six last week against Pittsburgh. Beauty. Backing up is Murphy. Looking for Rome. Penalty flag is two. Murphy. Far side. Another penalty flag. Now that surely is coming back. A 44-yard punt, 5 yards on the return. Say one thing, this officiating critic got some good arms, because these flags are coming in from distance.
From they all over the lot.
Those flags have hang time.
They may have to ice down around halftime.
Gerard McGinn and his crew. Veteran Big East officials. 10-0 South Florida. Greg Robinson's ball club. He's had a couple of big plays, but just as soon as they get something positive,
multiple
they go
flags
backwards.
On the play. Legal block in the back. Number four. That penalty is declined. Holding on South Florida. Number six. That penalty is accepted. 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. First down.
Tyler Roberts, Mike Jenkins caught for the fouls. Take a break. Come back. 10-0 South Florida. 10-0 lead. Mike Ford, 1 yard run, and Alvarado, 42-yard field goal. We're in the second quarter, 11:24 to go. Grothy, 4 of 7 passes, 32 yards, all four to Mitchell. And he's rushed four times for 26 yards. Big hole again. There's a penalty flag coming in late as Mike Ford picks up about two, maybe three, brought down by Joe Fields.
Holding on the offense, number 77. 10-yard penalty remains. First down.
Well, their penalty total, John, is just mounting. It's unbelievable. Seventh penalty today for 60 yards.
Yeah, seven today and 27 in the last three games. So they're definitely lacking discipline and falling from the ranks at the same time. You see week 7 in the BCS and the AP, ranked second in the country, and you go fast forward all the way down to week 10. They're not ranked, and that, you know, that'll get you gray hairs on the sideline for Jim Leavitt.
It was 30-27 to Rutgers, lost at UConn 22-15, and last week to Cincinnati by 5. Grothy all day over the middle. Two receivers right there. They both thought they had it. Hester Jr., number 87, and Carlton Mitchell. Grothy has now missed four consecutive passes.
Well, if you're Matt Grothy, you come back and try to get the guys and say, where are we running here? We got two guys in the same spot, but somebody catch it. I threw it right in the middle. Somebody take control and catch the football. Went right through the hands of Mitchell and then out through the hands of Jesse Hester Jr. They got to straighten out the routes there.
Second and 19. Grothy looking for a hole to find a run and fine defensive play by Syracuse. But Tribby, number 94, he's a freshman from Richmond, Virginia. Nice play in the middle.
Yeah, he stayed at home, did Tribby. Only a freshman waiting for Matt Grothy. Almost in like a spy technique, Dave. He thought it was going to be a quarterback draw. Tribby stayed at home and made the big tackle on second down. Now South Florida in third and very, very long.
South Florida 0 for 2 today on third down. For the season, they're sixth in the conference at 34%. Third and 18. Syracuse rushes four. Grothy hangs. It opens up wide. He's going to pick up a block, but to no avail. Nice play, Mike Mealy, freshman from Seagirt, New Jersey, the Manasquan High School. And South Florida's going to have to punt. Good defensive stand by Syracuse.
Yeah, they did a nice job of trying to regain some field position for Dantley in that offense, and they just need their one play away, Dave, from getting in this football game and really threatening South Florida.
It's Alvarado. Kicks, place kicks, okay, and punts. Alvarado, third in the Big East, his second punt today. Good snap. Oh, he crushed this one. That's going to back up Ryan Howard to the 35. Beats the first wave, second wave, got an alley. Down the sideline, one man to beat, there he goes! And they're going to say he stepped out of bounds back at the Syracuse 47-yard line. A 50-yard punt, 17 yards on the return. Alvarado out kicked his coverage.
Boy, what a great kick and missed tackles by South Florida, but you have to credit Howard. I'm not sure if he stepped out. I have to take another look at that, but Howard trying to walk the tightrope on the Syracuse sidelines. We're going to get another look right here.
Yeah, there it
is. That right there, yeah.
He was right there, yeah.
Good call. The official right there on the spot calls him.
Todd Reese, the line.
He stepped out again as well, but a good job by Ryan Howard making the first two Bulls miss and trying to get instant field position for this orange offense.
Ryan White, the O coordinator for Syracuse, said they throw it 40 times. See if they get to that now. Penalty flag. Goodness gracious. And they Danley threw it anyway. He's got a nice arm, John. You're gonna like that.
I like his attitude. He's not afraid to press the issue offensively.
Prior to snap. Offsides on the defense. Number 76. There was contact on the center. 5-yard penalty remains. First down.
Nine penalties, 74 yards. Just Brian White with the. So you're right behind the gentleman right there. There he is right there.
Yeah, he was good talking with him yesterday. He says, you know, our kids are practicing hard. The only problem is when I look and see USF on film, you know, it's like the Hogan Heroes episode with Sergeant Schultz. I see nothing. There's not a lot of holes on this Bull defense.
That's saying a lot for a club that's lost three in a row. Be amazing. Nice snap. Dantley. Got to get a running game going. Boy, he paid the price. Kenzie tattooed 3 yards on the game. Close to a first down. He's 2 yards short.
You know, with this Syracuse offense, they have to get consecutive positive plays going. You know, one good play, they get a good gain on first down. Dantley runs it to the short side. Yes, he takes a pop from Tyrone McKenzie, but he pops up and gets back on the field. And on the flip side, Tyrone McKenzie, back-to-back weeks, is having a nice game here. Great game last week in the loss at home against Cincinnati.
Transfer from Iowa State. I love it when you can take that running back's momentum and push him backwards. Second and short. Look out.
That's
intercepted. That's intercepted. That's going to stand. He threw it a lateral backwards shot. As you correctly said, it went off the helmet of a Syracuse player right into the arms of Alan Cray. Second turnover today by Syracuse. They did that one, and that goes with the opening kickoff.
Well, first of all, you have to be tipped off. There's two fullbacks in the backfield, and then you have one of the wide receivers looping around in Smith. It was going to be maybe a double pass or a to the outside and then throwing it down the field to Mike Williams. But we were just talking about making back-to-back positive plays. You can't make that play if you're Cameron Dantley. You just made a nice run on first down. You get him in good field position and then just eat the football. It's better to take the sack.
Went off the helmet of Tony Fiametta, the fullback. There's Samuels in motion. He went 75 last time, and here he goes again. He's got room on the sideline. Got a great block inside the 30. First down, South Florida. Dwayne Davis again. Another saving tackle that time. 26 yards for Aston Samuels.
Two great blocks for Samuels. Jamar Taylor, the tailback. You're going to see him come outside the block right on the edge up top, and then a terrific job downfield by Carlton Mitchell. Big play for the Bulls on first down.
First and 10 at the 27. Samuels in motion again. Straight up they got with Ford rambling ahead for about 7. Samuels, two runs, John, for 101 yards. You like that average?
Yeah, you love that average. And what the Bulls are doing a little bit differently with their run game, they're taking the pressure off of Grothy and putting it on the tailback, and they're doing a good job of bringing somebody behind Grothy that's limiting what Syracuse can do on the edge defensively.
South Florida goes with two tight ends, solo receivers both sides. Run forward, oh, there's a good defensive play. Ran right into him. And he does a fine job. That was Andrew Lewis. Sarah Kustak, what do you have?
Dave, critical interception there for South Florida. And they said that they've got great hands so far this season. A lot of that is because of priority on pass catching skills in practice. They said that the defense is doing a lot of the same stuff that the receivers do, and it makes a lot of difference. This lot of those interceptions because of the way that they're working on all the pass catchers.
15 on the season, too. So 15 interceptions recorded by South Florida. Blitz coming. Quick pop down to the 15-yard line. That's a first down. They got it to Torres Johnson coming off an ankle. Picks up 7 first down Bulls.
Good solid throw by Matt Groth. He just catches the shotgun snap, gets the laces, and delivers a bullet over the middle to the junior from Cape Coral, Florida.
That's a good throw.
Another big stand. This Syracuse defense, they came up big last series defensively. Can they do it again?
From the 15. Got a man wide open. Touchdown. Wow, is that stealing? Carlton Mitchell. They used every fake in the book. He just sauntered right down the hash mark. A 15-yard TD. It's 16-0 South Florida.
Dave,
that says it all right there.
That was pretty. That's a pretty offensive play. You fake the tailback. You fake the bubble screen. And you get your big track star on the outside, Carlton Mitchell, wide open.
Carlton Mitchell's third TD catch of the season for Grothy. That's TD pass number 10 to go with 10 picks. Alvarado point after is good. So five play 47, make that five catches for 47 yards and a touchdown. But Grothy, great fake here. The execution right on time and a blocking. Not bad either. 17-0 Bulls. Does Mr. Mitchell have world-class speed? He's got a world-class Grohawk haircut.
Well, if you want the football in this offense, you go to the Grohawk. Five plays, 53 yards, only a minute 50 off the clock in the 15-yard touchdown, and that's begging. When you go to that, that's begging.
I'll show you more Matt Grothy a little bit later on. He's got that Mohawk haircut. Max Suter already established a Big East record for most yards. A nice return again to about the 30, 29 yards. 26 yards on the return. Take a look at how this touchdown developed, John. It was a beauty.
It really was. At first, it's the fake handoff, and then Grothy's going to fake the bubble screen outside. But Williams, all he does, or Mitchell, all he does is go to the outside. Watch the defenders. One, two, three. They're all coming this direction, and it's a great play fake by Matt Grothy. First the fake on the handoff, then the bubble screen, and then the easy pitch and catch for 6.
Grothy's got to get his Grohawk a little shaped up there. Syracuse running the ball today, 9 carries for 4 yards. Paul Sciarra for maybe 1-2 tops. Let's check in with Syracuse stock again.
Dave, Carlton Mitchell impacting the football field here, but he's also a track star for USF. He holds the USF record in the 400 meters, and Grothy says, you know what, he's a big, lanky guy. I just kind of look for that streak of green running across the field, and I can normally find Carlton.
And of late, Sarah, he's had time to do it, too. It's just a matter sometimes, you know, we were talking to South Florida people last week. Hey, can Matt throw it far enough? Because the kid's going to get out.
Yeah. You have to throw it on time when you're going to number 2.
In trouble. Down he goes. Alan Cray's going to get a piece of that. And I think it was Selvey was the first one in there to slow him up. Second team sack today. These guys are getting out of the gate like it's a Kentucky Derby.
Well, they're licking their chops up front. They know that Syracuse has been having problems protecting the quarterback. Last week against the Panthers in a loss, they gave up 6 sacks. And today, it's just a feast back there in that Syracuse backfield of Salvey and Alan Gray and Woody George and Klebert. They've been all doing a great job of winning the battle off the line of scrimmage, and they've been timing it on the edge perfectly.
The Orange 1-for-4 on third down today, third and long here. 17-0. Manley waiting, throws a deep ball, got a man down there, triple coverage, overthrown, tried to feed it into Taj Smith. Mike Jenkins and Louis Gachette among those covering. It's not pretty.
No, you know, Dave, when you have a lot of pressure, you may want to move the pocket a little bit and try to get your athlete at quarterback on the edge, give him a comeback and a curl combination or a flat and curl combination and try to move the pocket and make it a little bit easier for that offensive line to protect.
Long to punt again. It's 4th punt. Murphy's back there. Oh, beauty. That's at the 11. Might as well just let it go in the end zone, and it does. 4-3 hang time on a 73-yard punt. That was a fine effort. And his previous long was 64, so that's a season long for Rob Long. And be sure to join us next Saturday at noon Eastern time. Pittsburgh will be traveling to Central New Jersey. Take on the Scarlet Knights of Rutgers. Check your local listings for the game in your area. Rutgers coming off a win last night. They overmatched Army.
And how about the running of Ray Rice? Almost 300 carries on the season.
That leads the country in carries. Was it
294?
294. Wow.
If you're a backup running back at Syracuse, you got to start asking for the football. Give him a break, coach. Yeah.
Fill in your name. I'm a backup running back at Rutgers, just watching.
Yeah, right now I'm just taking notes.
Timeout on the field. Fish's timeout.
Looks like Bud Tribby's down again for the Orange.
17-0 South Florida. Mike Ford, a 1-yard run. Alvarado, a 42-yard field goal. And Grothy to Mitchell with nobody home in the secondary, a 15-yarder after Samuels had set it up with a 26-yard reverse.
Yeah, and after Greg Robinson's defense the series before, they go first and goal on the 3, they get it to the 1, and then they penalties back up South Florida. They take advantage the second time in, does Greg Gregory and that offensive coordinator. Great call for the Bulls on that fake run, fake bubble, and down the middle.
Take a look at our Polaris out-of-town scoreboard. The Penn State Nittany Lions playing in Philly against Temple at the link, 14-0.
Wisconsin.
The Badgers 17-7 over Michigan.
Michigan had that come from behind victory last week against the Spartans of Michigan State.
Wisconsin played Ohio State tough last week for about a little bit into
quarter,
the
almost
a little bit into
half-time.
The second, and boy, there was a couple of cutback runs off of I
that
formation.
Was
oh man,
that was how you draw it up.
And Beckman made some nice throws too for Ohio State. Here's Grothy in a little semi-roll, gets it out. That's a first down to the 30-plus to Marcus Edwards. Nick Chestnut gets him out of bounds. 12 yards on the pickup.
That's an example, Dave, when your offensive line is struggling a little bit. That's a perfect play to get your quarterback on track, and you'd look for the Orange to do a little bit of that in the second half, but Matt Grothy, just a half roll, nice and controlled. It's an easy pitch and catch to the outside.
Matt Grothy just went beyond the 2,000-yard mark for this season. Work under center from the 34, first and 10. Trap play. Breaking a tackle. Nice job by the running back, Mike Ford. And how about the block? Boy, Mark Dial, the tackle trap. How about that?
That's a big body coming at you
in
the hole.
Goodness.
Big number 78. Mark Dial, he injured his right knee, it looked like, earlier in the game, but
he had some giddy up.
He was on top speed there coming on the pulling.
Oh.
That was a good job by Dial.
Nice to see that one up there, not as an inside linebacker. You turn to your right and go, oh.
Do I have to? Yeah.
Second down and 6 at the 39. He's got some time. He did a bunch of checkdowns. First down close to first down to him. And in fact, it is a first down. He's right at the 45. So he did a check down. He got Cedric Hill, his tight end, a junior from Valdosta, Georgia.
We credit Mark Dial on that pull on the running play, the play before. Let's credit the rest of those guys up front. Great protection for Matt Grothy to scan from left to right and finally find a wide open receiver on the outside in Cedric Hill.
Karn, Schmidt, Griffin, Herman, and Dial. Look at the total yards. Yikes. Four-man rush, quarterback draw, Grothy hunting and pecking, not finding a whole lot. Took some punishment, too. Got back to the line of scrimmage. That was it. Mike Mealy making the stop. But Joe Fields, I can't begin to tell you how impressed I am with him. He came in as a heralded quarterback here at Syracuse, wanted to leave last year. We told you a story earlier this year about Greg Robinson. Said, hey, you should come back. You got a chance to play in the pros as a safety. I don't think there's any question about it.
No, great anticipation, and you can tell every game we have of the Orange, the anticipation gets better. The tackling in the open field gets better. He's doing a terrific job in that safety spot.
And it centers a running play. Ford, hard yardage, picks up about 4. Let down by the middle linebacker, Jake Flaherty. Let's get more on Joe Fields. Here's Sarah Kustak.
about Joe Fields. A few years back, he goes into Robinson's office and he says, "Coach, you know, I just want to be on the field. I want to play," and ask for his release. And Greg Robinson says, "You know what? I look at this kid and he epitomizes Syracuse football. And I thought, how can I keep this guy here? How do I get him on the field?" And that started his switch over to safety, which he's had a successful career so far.
He's done a real nice job. Here's a third down and six. Brophy, time, middle, yes, at the 40. First down to Hester Jr., Jesse Hester Jr. for 13. Dwayne Davis brings him down. Jesse Hester Jr., dad played for the Raiders, Colts, Falcons, and Rams. Dantley's dad played in the NBA, as we've told you.
Great job of getting behind the linebackers here by Hester Jr. Just that little bubble behind the linebackers and in front of the safeties. And when Matt Grothy has time to set his feet, his best throw is that seam or bending route across the middle. He can deliver on time.
Hester's a classic slot receiver, going for it all. Throws short to Hill. They're going on a flyer to Mitchell down the near right sideline, bottom of your screen. That was the initial look. Neely makes the stop. Hill. Oh, can we just play football, please? Hill and Fields having a debate. Go to a football game and a debate broke out. I want to tell you.
It was a good catch, good tackle. Everybody can go back to the huddle and try to duplicate it on second down.
Hey, still got a $1.54 to tattoo somebody legally. Second down play, Grove. Get it to Mitchell. Boy, see something. Joe Fields knocks him out of bounds. A tackle missed by Nick Chestnut. Picks up 14.
Well, he's just so big, David. 6'4", almost 200 pounds. A redshirt freshman. And he shows you the toughness on that play. Just a good job by Chestnut trying to make the tackle. But the size of Carlton Mitchell and the toughness of Carlton Mitchell on the edge just breaks that tackle and uses his speed on the edge.
Penalty flags all over. Everybody raining flags as Ford runs up the middle for about three or four. Last week we saw Benjamin Williams, as tough a little guy as you've ever seen. And I don't think he's the best running back I've seen this year, pro or college, in terms of picking up blitz. Benjamin Williams,
pretty
not
good,
even in
yeah.
the game. I mean, he blew people up all last week in the Cincinnati.
There are multiple flags on the play. Legal substitution on the defense. 12th player was running off the field. Holding on the offense, number 76. Penalties offset, replay, first down.
The energetic Jim Leavitt, head coach of the South Florida Bulls. 1:37 to go, coming up, the American Century Investments halftime report. Preview that big UConn-Cincinnati game, a get-to-know-you segment with Matt Grothy and today. First half stats and highlights. 10th play of this drive, which started back at the 20-yard line. Ford, workman-like again. Ford's having a nice day. Freshman out of Sarasota. Had 300 yards coming in. He's rushed 12 times for 50 yards today. So South Florida calls a timeout. Two remaining for the Bulls, one for Syracuse. Grothy's got a TD pass. Ford's got a TD run. And Alvarado, a 42-yard field goal, counting for the score. Biggie standings. Certainly not what everybody predicted. Louisville at 2-3. South Florida had been number two in the country at 1-3 in the conference, trying to get out of the cellar with the Syracuse Orange. Let's take a look at this week's Suzuki College Way of Life. Ben Moffitt, married dad of two, commutes 55 miles. It's a 110 round trip per day to USF. Butkus Award semifinalist, top linebacker in the nation.
Had a birthday of one of his children last week, 5 years old. He's a leader on that defense.
Samuels is in the backfield. Syracuse shows blitz. Grothy sees him. Takes a snap. Looking to get rid of it. Keeps it alive. Grothy throws it away. Boy, he's a heck of an athlete. Heck of an athlete, because he was totally outmanned. But he's got great quicks.
He just has that sense of somebody's coming, I got to get out of here. And every quarterback has to have that clock in your head where you're back and you feel the pressure coming, you see the pressure coming, but he has the escapability to get to the right side of the field and not make a bad play worse.
Double wides for Grothier. He's 11 of 16, 105 yards and a touchdown. Oh, he's got people open. Going to throw a man in the end zone. Johnson's there. Oh, Johnson gave up on the play. He was the man. He could have made the play. Edwards made the last explosion to get it, but that ball looked like it was right to Johnson.
I think Matt Grothier had Johnson in his sights the whole way, and it looked like Johnson gave up on the route.
Well, he was there and led perfectly.
Looked like everybody was going to run a curl route here. Grothy feels a little pressure, but then Johnson breaks to the corner, and you're going to see Matt Grothy come off of the right side, look to the left side. Now watch, this area here is where the ball's going, and Johnson just gives up on the route. If he sprints through that, I think it's six.
33 yards on this attempt by Delbert Alvarado. He's already hit from 42. Snap, placement kick. Again, well struck. And three and more on the board for the South Florida Bulls. Alvarado two for two with 63 seconds to go here in the second quarter.
And this score could be 28-0 right now. This defense of Syracuse, two times they come inside the 20, do the Bulls, and they hold them to field goals on both opportunities.
Can't say enough about the effort by Dwayne Davis to tackle Samuels on that 75-yard run, and this is what the Bulls are playing for today. Guarantees them a bowl, third straight year. Moreover, it ends a three-game losing streak. 13-play drive, 64 yards, and 4:25.
Jim Leavitt having his team playing at a high level, and they've been close in the last couple of weeks, but they've lost three in a row, and they've... We're at the number two ranking in the country in the BCS. They lose on the road at Rutgers. And last week, and they had two chances at the end of the game to pull the game out against Cincinnati. And one was a tough catch by Carlton Mitchell, and the other may have been interference on the last play. Cincinnati gets the victory.
Borderline call, no doubt about it. Could have gone either way. Went against him. As poorly, they give up 31 first quarter points and still in the game. Says a lot about this ball club.
Really does.
Alvarado to kick. High short kick. Suter running up to get it about the 18-yard line. Trying to get to the edge. Nothing there. They force him back into traffic. And a nice job in there. Ben, and 12 yards on the return. We get more on Ben Moffitt here, Sarah.
Dave, a day in the life of Ben Moffitt. Most college athletes think they have it tough. Ben Moffitt has a little different. Gets up, dresses his kids Trevor and Rylan, and then makes that 55-mile drive to USF, as we talked about. Hits some communication classes, just enough time to grab lunch, can't even finish a sandwich. It's weights, film, practice, and then a 55-mile drive all the way back home, 12-hour day for Ben Moffitt.
Hopefully he'll be getting paid for his efforts, maybe not necessarily in the Tampa area, as that's an incompletion of Nishwa. Penalty flag on the play. About last night watching a Rutgers-Army game, we're talking about the Army cadets. 20 minutes for lunch.
Yeah, that's a tough day. I know this part, the wake up and the dress kids, but all this has gone away. And then this part I know like very
that.
Well. Yeah.
You like that one.
Yeah.
John driving home after 27 holes. Yeah. A little bit of
on
practice.
Offense, number 80. He was covered up. 5-yard penalty remains. First down.
Yeah, I don't want to go into my senior year with what my schedule looked like.
Is that right?
It was, 6:45.
Just stumbling
Dean,
in?
Meet Dean at golf course.
Work on sand game.
Work. Yeah, make sure you have lunch before film study. Practice. Tell everybody live what you shot.
First and 15, under minute to play. Less than a minute. Good slant. Williams makes the catch. Dangerous play.
Fumble.
Ball. Is that alive? I believe it is. It is. South Florida ball. Third turnover by Syracuse. Bruce Mompremier makes the recovery. The linebacker, Carlton Williams, forced the fumble. Let's see. 43 seconds. You're up 20-0.
That's a good throw. on the slant route. Mike Williams tucks it away initially, and then the strip right there. It looked like 32. Carlton Williams on the strip. It's a good protection, good throw. Mike fighting for yards, but 32 comes in. Carlton Williams, he's a smart player. He's been playing closer to the line of scrimmage. He comes up with big plays, and none bigger than that one right there.
He saw Haruki Nakamura do that last week for Cincinnati. Nakamura had a fabulous game last week. Free safety for the Bearcats. Here's Grothy trying to cash it in. And he's got a man down there, and it's picked off by Joe Fields. He was trying to get Johnson. Fields with 35 seconds to go. He's got a lot of open space. Picks up a block. Somebody wants the helmet. Here's Joe Fields. If he cuts back, he does, and gets it all the way back to the 43-yard line. Penalty flag on the play. How about Ryan Schmidt lost his helmet? The helmet must have rolled 20 yards. 58 yards on the return of the interception by Joe Fields. That's his fourth of the season. You see Schmidt's helmet?
Yeah.
That was scary.
This is the second time in a row it looked like one of the receivers quit on the route. It looked like Johnson again. The ball was well overthrown, and all you have to do is play center field if you're Joe Fields. But that helmet, we can't see it on that replay, but it's rolling around the 50-yard line.
Back-to-back turnovers. 27 seconds remain here in the first half.
I think they may get Nick Santiago, 95, with a personal foul.
Multiple flags on the play. Holding on South Florida, number 65. That penalty's declined. Nickel block in the back on Syracuse, number 55. That penalty will be accepted from the spot of the foul. 10-yard penalty, first down, Syracuse.
Gerard McGinn, thank you very much. Well, that is some laundry list. Take a look at what happened to Ryan Schmidt. Look at a helmet. Watch this baby roll. He gets contacted.
There's the helmet.
Yeah.
It's in the air here, and it's going to get a good bounce about the 42-yard line. Goes to about the 44. Jeez. It's picking up speed.
It outran Joe.
Yeah. It's coming back to try to make the tackle on Joe Fields.
Oh, my goodness. Back at the 20. Four-man rush by the Bulls. Gantley down the middle. Heck of a catch. First down. Dropped. What do we got? You're going to say he was down. Goes out of bounds. That's going to remain his ball anyway. So Syracuse ball to the 40. 20 yards on the pass to J.J. Neswa with the tight end.
This is a good throw and a great catch by the tight end, J.J. Neswa. I watch him go up, hand catch up at the top. Gets the front of that football. A good hit, but still hangs on to the football. The hit was by Nate Allen.
First catch today by Neswa. Smith in space. Thrown out of bounds by Nate Allen. Nate should have kept him in bounds. 7 seconds to go. Stops the clock, a 20-yard pickup.
Yeah, and Jonathan Meldrum down for the orange, way back at the 35-yard line.
Done some rotation on that offensive line for the orange today. Started with Cheevers at left tackle. They moved him out. They had Bombach on there. He got blitzed by Selby. Meldrum's in there.
Well, it looks like to me, Dave, if you're head coach Greg Robinson and offensive coordinator Brian White, you've got 7 seconds left. You want to turn Cameron Dantley loose, get him a pass into the end zone, either get pass interference, make a big play, have a chance to kick the field goal, or get the touchdown on the last play. But when you come out in this second half, whatever the score is, go no huddle, give it to the young quarterback making his first start, open up this offense, and just, if you're going to go down slinging it all over the lot. Because this is how you got your playmakers on the outside in Smith and Williams. You got a big catch by your tight end, Neswa. Open up this offense and go down in flames. If you're going to lose, go down firing.
Dantley 8 for 14. Let me get that soapbox out of here.
Okay? There's not enough room to get it out of here. I'm going to be on it.
You are right on. You are right on. 8 for 14, Dantley, today for .124 and an interception. 7 seconds to go here in the first half. Four-man rush. Far side. Nice catch. Williams gets out of bounds. Stops the clock with 3 seconds. That's a long throw.
That is.
The opposite hash.
That ball never left. I mean, that velocity on that football was there.
Man, there's a lot to like for this kid.
I think the upside for Cameron Dantley is just enormous.
All right, so Shadle has a chance for a field goal. a 50-yard attempt. He's 0-for-1 this year. It's 24-30 field goals in his career. Junior out of Morgantown, West Virginia. 50 yards on the attempt. John Barker to hold. And now Jim Leavitt's going to ice it. Jim going to come all the way out in the field, too.
South Florida. That's his second charge, time out of the half.
Jim Leavitt coming all the way out in the field to talk to his field goal block unit.
It may be one of those, hey, don't jump off sides. It's a long enough field goal already, and make him earn it.
Come out low, too.
Yeah, make him earn it.
Danley's got a good arm. How far? That throw from this, the near hash to the far sideline.
That's about a 40-yard, you know, 40-yard throw.
Yeah.
35, 40-yard throw on about a 12-yard out route.
And it was there pretty much, he, you know, hung it out to dry, huh?
Oh, yes, he did.
Good-looking throw.
Yeah, in the old days, you could say, you can hang some laundry on that because that was a rope.
And it was probably longer in the old days when they had the crown field.
Yeah.
Right? I remember you said you were, yeah. We were talking about that earlier in the year. From the right hash, Shadle out of Morgantown, West Virginia. 0-for-1 from 50 games so far this year. A chance. It's good. Orange on the board. It's 20-3 at halftime. The Shadle. Nice little draw.
Nailed it.
Might have been good from another 5 yards out. One little emotional lift. Syracuse to get the ball. Well, they'll be kicking off when we come back halftime. And here's a look at it from the right hash. Beauty. Nice job by Patrick Shadle. Greg Robinson can need some positive reinforcement. 20-3 South Florida. Welcome to the American Century Investments Halftime Report. Big East football from Syracuse, New York. We're at the Carrier Dome on a cold, windy day here in Syracuse, South Florida, paying a visit to the Syracuse Orange. Let's take a look now at our Polaris out-of-town scoreboard. Big East action earlier this week. John, West Virginia, in terms of style points, and they got the win, but style points, they didn't rack them up.
Yeah, they were up 17 at one point, and then they had to rely on the legs of Pat White, that big run with under 2 minutes to go to pull the game out. And then last night, Ray Rice goes crazy, and Rutgers continues back towards that winning trend in being a team they should have beaten in Army.
Coming up later on today, we've got a very important game of the Big East Conference. It involves the number one team in the conference, the Connecticut Huskies. How about that? They're at Cincinnati, where the Bearcats are always tough.
Well, the Connecticut group this year under Randy Edsall, they don't make mistakes, and they're doing a great job of ball hawking and getting those interceptions. And the Bearcats, they're doing a great job of taking it away as well. So the team that protects the football should win this football game.
As we look at the standings in the Big East Conference, Connecticut on top. They've got a one-game lead on West Virginia. They had them in a couple of weeks. Cincinnati, Pittsburgh. Pittsburgh's still in the hunt for a good bowl game.
Yeah, they're on that upward trend. They have to finish strong. But, you know, who could believe a couple of months ago, you see the Connecticut Huskies up top, 4-0 in the conference, 8-1, making noise on a national presence.
Congratulations to Randy Edsall and everybody at the Connecticut program. As we look forward in the Big East, next Saturday, noon Eastern, Pittsburgh takes on Rutgers. We'll be there. As we watch the Panthers take on the Scarlet Knights, make sure you check your local listings for the game in your area. When we come back, we'll meet Matt Grothy. He's the quarterback for the South Florida Bulls, an interesting young man. You'll get to know him right after this. Back, everybody, to the American Century Investments Halftime Report. Syracuse taking on South Florida. Right now, it's time for our Get to Know You feature. And today's subject is South Florida quarterback Matt Grothy.
Hi, I'm sophomore quarterback Matt Grothy from the University of South Florida.
The most influential person in my life by far has been my dad.
Well, ever since I was young, I've loved to hunt, and nothing else I'd rather do besides be in the woods if I'm out playing football.
Probably the biggest thing I love about my truck is that, you know, every time somebody jumps into it, they complain about how high it is and how they hate getting into it.
Well, my mom thinks I'm crazy for having it. I cut it about every 2 weeks, and I get people telling me, you know, they don't like how long the middle is, or, you know, they like it, they think I should grow it out longer in the middle. And I don't know exactly what I'm gonna do with it yet and exactly why I still have it, but probably because I'm very superstitious and
it ain't going nowhere until at least the end of the season.
Nothing else I'd rather be doing at the time than being out there on the football field.
That's really good. That is really good.
How can you not love this guy? I mean, players must gravitate to what he does. He's such a dynamic player on the field, but off the field, that's why people work for this guy so hard and play for Matt Grothy.
And he certainly means a great deal to this football program, no question about it. We'll take a break when we come back to Syracuse, New York. We'll have a look at the first half stats and highlights. Big East football from Central New York. We're back after this. Welcome back, everybody, to the American Century Investment Halftime Report. 20-3 South Florida over Syracuse here at halftime, second half, moments away. Glad you could join us, everybody, for Big East football. Dave Sims along with Jack and Jimmy and Sarah Kustak. South Florida could be up even bigger, but Syracuse gets an emotional boost to get that 50-yard field goal at the final gun to end the first half.
Well, they did a good job trying to get on the scoreboard, and they did just before halftime. But special teams was a theme last week that hurt them on the road at Pittsburgh. They started the football game, and it hurt them right away on kickoff return.
Sure did. South Florida, on the opening kickoff, gets it down to Max Suter, and then disaster strikes as we look at our PNC first half highlights.
Yeah, the Bulls take advantage of this opportunity right on the opening kickoff. A one-yard run. Mike Ford off the right side goes untouched. It's 7-0 Bulls. And then a big play in the second quarter. Samuels gets a 75-yard run. It looked like he was shot out of a cannon, Dave. Goes down the Syracuse sidelines. It was a big play to hold him from a touchdown. And they get a nice touchdown there, opportunity on the 3-yard line. But Grothy takes advantage of that opportunity. A 15-yarder to Carlton Mitchell to push the score to 17-0. But the stats, you can see the rushing yards, only 2 yards for the Cuse. The Polaris first half stats, only 2 yards rushing. Turnovers, 3 for the Orange as well. And points off of turnovers, 14 for the Bulls. So Syracuse, as we said, or as I said, going to halftime, going to need to throw the football in the second half, protect for the young quarterback, but do something through the air.
See what develops. 20-3. South Florida over Syracuse. Second half kickoff is coming up next.
Here, but it's getting hotter for head coach Jim Leavitt, who definitely kept it short and sweet. Asked him about Grothy's interception. He said, you know what, it was just a bad throw. There's nothing we could do. But on offense, we need to protect the football better. Defensively, we've got to stop the run and have to stop those big plays. For Greg Robinson in Syracuse, before a question was even asked, he said, yes, we needed that, in reference to the field goal. He said, our defense has been on the field way too long, and our offense has had too many shots at the end zone not to have made anything happen.
All right, Sarah, stay warm down there. Greg Robinson in the orange. See if they go the Can Jimmy doctrine and eschew the run. Fill the air with football.
Well, you know, you have to protect against George Sylvie on the edge and Alan Cray and Woodney George, that defensive line for the Bulls. But in some aspects, you have to open it up and let your main weapons, which are Smith and Williams on the outside, along with Neshwa at the tight end spot, take over the football game for you. You're only down 17 points, so this is an opportunity for Syracuse's defense to come out, go 3 plays and out, get good field position back, and try to make something happen in the second half.
On the ground, Syracuse net rushing, 2 yards in 11 attempts.
Yeah, not good.
USF a 180. Here we go. Here comes South Florida, about the 15-yard line. Got some space. Fighting to the 41-yard line. Murphy on the return for 27 yards.
That Bulls offense led by Matt Grothy in the first half. You know, last week, Dave, against Cincinnati, had a school record, 382 yards passing. You see the numbers today, one touchdown, one interception, but the good mix of run and pass.
Ideal starting position from the 40. Edwards in motion. They run up the middle. Ford. Very steady. Gives him a legit threat between the tackles today. Jameel McClain. McClain making the tackle. A win today for the Bulls. Guarantees third consecutive season in a bowl game, and it would end that three-game losing streak. After six in a row, they lost to Rutgers at Rutgers 30-27. At UConn 22-15, and last week at home. There's Ford bouncing it outside. First down, got a nice block. No penalty flags as he gets to the 39 of Syracuse after a 14-yard run.
Boy, it looked like Syracuse was in position for that cutback, but the speed and agility of Mike Ford bouncing it outside. A first down on the initial carry of the second half from Mike Ford. Great job of bouncing that outside, and now Grothy to take advantage of terrific field position.
You make a great point. There's been a lot of times Syracuse defense has been in good position, but they get outmaneuvered with the speed. Ford, 14 carries, 69 yards. Grothy on a keeper, follows Ford. He's got a first down. 27-yard line, first down. 12 yards on the game. Mike Holmes brings him down.
Well, we saw Mike Ford being elusive. Matt Grothy, watch him. Brandon Gilbo in blue, right in the right spot to make the tackle. Almost breaks his ankle going for Matt Grothy, and Grothy just takes it up the gut again for another Bulls first down.
Again, in position, get out quick.
If you get him in space, you can make him miss, and that's what the South Florida Bulls are doing.
Ford slams ahead. Number 46, redshirt freshman out of Brooklyn, New York, and South Shore High School.
Well, Syracuse's defense, Dave, late in that second quarter was in this position twice, and they really did a good job of holding South Florida to field goals. Now South Florida with a little bit of momentum coming out after halftime. Let's see what happens in this series.
Second down and eight at the 25, opening series. Third quarter, here comes a reverse. We get it to Samuels. Great block by Grothy. He's got the edge. There's another block to the 10. Nicely done. Carlton Mitchell on the reverse. Nico Scott finally got him out of bounds. 16 yards on the game.
Well, you called it, Dave. A terrific block by Grothy. The handoff's going to go here. We're going to get the pitch coming behind to Carlton Williams. And watch Grothy on the block right here. There's the block by the quarterback, and it's free sailing to the outside. One guy to make miss to the end zone, and a big tackle by Davis again.
First and goal. Here's Ford to the six. McClain on the tackle. I think the analogy we're looking for, hot knife and butter.
Yeah. I mean, South Florida coming out, they're not hurting themselves. They're not the penalties they were making in the first half on these drives that were drive breakers. South Florida in this drive's six straight rushes for 53 yards, and Jim Leavitt's got that pace going on the sidelines that the Bulls have on the field.
Using the entire 53-and-a-half-yard width. Nice move, Grothy. Picks up a block, scoots in. He's got a touchdown. Got a nice block by a wide receiver. He set up a nice cut to his right. They got an injured player, the left tackle, Jared Carnes. South Florida adding to its total. It's 26-3.
The Bulls come out and run the football effectively. They had it in great field position, but watch Grothy, a little bounce and then a bounce outside. Dave, in space, the Bulls have so much speed that they'll make you miss or make you take a bad angle, and that's exactly what they did in that series. A lot of bad angles and missed tackles lead to a Bulls touchdown.
Here's Alvarado. Operation is a success. A seven-play, 59-yard drive and 2:38 to open up the third quarter. Grothy with the touchdown run, 27-3. And coming up, the Zonk. Larry Zonk is going to stop by, chat with him right after this timeout from the Carrier Dome here in Syracuse. Welcome back, everybody. South Florida has a 27-3. Early third quarter lead here in Syracuse. Matt Grothy completed the drive with a 5-yard run. Opening drive of the third quarter. The Bulls en route to ending that three-game losing streak. Alvarado has it teed up. And here he comes.
Suter's going to back up, take it at his six. Max bounced around, takes it to about the 27-yard line. Up here in the booth, we are pleased to welcome one of the all-time greats here at Syracuse University and all the world, the football, Pro Football Hall of Famer, Larry Zonka. Zonka, good to see you. How are you?
Good to be here.
Good to have you here.
Actually, at my age, good to be anywhere.
I hear you. I hear you. Now, they retired your jersey today. Great honor for you this afternoon.
Yeah, for a power running back, it's a thrill to have your jersey retired. Of course, there's a lot of other people that put you up there, so you gotta admire them and that's their effort.
Your old line, right?
Yeah, my offensive line here at Syracuse, my offensive line with the Dolphins, same thing.
Well, it's always a good feeling, as you said at halftime, to feel like you're coming home. And it's a good feeling to come back and embrace, you know, you mentioned your coaches, your coaching staff, and the guys you played with, and you couldn't have done it without them. But, you know, the feeling of coming home to Syracuse, what does that mean to you?
Well, I lived here for 3.5-4 years and did a lot of fishing out around here and a lot of hunting out in the mountains. Used to play hooky with Chancellor Tully and go catch a few trout and on Mondays.
Right.
So it was great to be around here and got to know a lot of people other than just the university. But, of course, the university was the center piece of that. So it's nice to come back. Things have changed, but they've changed for the better. The university looks even better than it did back then.
This was a different playing field when you were here at Archbold Stadium.
Crumbling Archibald, saw myself, Jim Brown, Ernie Davis, Floyd Little, a lot of us played here, and it was literally crumbling in a turn-of-the-century facility that was falling down around us, but it had tremendous heritage. And I was glad that Ben Schwartzwalder was keynote, making sure that the dome got built on the footers that reached back to 1900 or so.
Good deal, no question about it. Tell the folks what you're doing these days, Larry.
I have a little hunting and fishing shows, Napa's north to Alaska, up in Alaska, doing it 12 years. Look at that catch. All right.
Boy, he's going. That Florida speed is going to bump Williams out of bounds. So a big play. Nate Allen stops the touchdown for the moment. So Mike Williams with a big play for the Orange.
There's a young Larry Zonka, the two-time All-American running back.
Look at that straight nose. Look at that. Look at that straight run.
Here it goes. Seen a lot of those runs.
Look
in the
at that
orange.
Speed. It's in high gear right there.
It's in.
I'm moving out on that defensive back. You know he's slow.
There you go. Right up the gut again for six.
What's your best memory of playing here?
I think being able to say that I played for Ben Schwartzwald and the great coaching staff we had here. Joe Zombadi, Rocky Pirro. We had great, great coaches that really took an interest in you. And I think that was a rarity back then, but I think it's pretty commonplace now. I think coaches are much more involved in their athletes' lives now, and that's a good thing.
Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. Well, good to have you here, and I'm glad. I remember reading a story about when you got stranded up Alaska. I'm glad to see you here in one piece. That was so.
Hey, I love the Coast Guard, buddy.
Oh, I bet you do.
And I don't mind paying my taxes anymore.
Larry, if you're not familiar, get stranded up in Alaska. What was that, about 6 months or a year
Bering
ago?
Bering Sea, it was about 2 years ago. We spent a long 17 hours out on the Bering Sea in 20-25-foot waves and 50-knot winds. It was rough.
So a salute to the Coast Guard, right?
Yeah.
Absolutely. They're my guys.
All right. Larry, good to see you. All the best to you.
Thank you.
Good to see you. Congratulations again, Larry.
Go Orange.
There's Dantley looking for six. The screen to Hogue. We haven't seen Hogue in a while. He's got the edge. He's got the first down. He's inside the five. First and goal, Syracuse.
He's all fired up about this Orange getting in the end zone.
Absolutely.
Showing his colors, as you should, right?
Nice to hear this place come to life again with the offense doing some productive things.
Yeah, doing a good job here. A little screen pass. Dantley retreating. Finds Doug Hogue, who we haven't mentioned really the entire first half, and he gets the football inside the five down to the three.
Boy, I tell you what, some spirited blocking. On the old line, Carroll Madison at left tackle against Selvig. They made that adjustment midway through the first quarter. Dantley's going to throw. That time back in the end zone.
Oh, what a catch! Oh my goodness! Wow! Mike Williams went up and got it—a laser shot from Cameron Dantley. Touchdown, Syracuse.
Dave, you want to talk about climbing the ladder for the ball? Dantley has great protection provided. He gets hit right at the end of the play, so he hangs tough. But what a hand catch up top. Mike Williams goes up and gets the football between Nate Allen and Mike Jenkins. Terrific job of going up to see the strength of that catch.
Allen Cray unloaded on Dantley, and that kid had the guts to hang in there. Point after shade will count it.
to the Orange with the first touchdown of the day. I'm telling you, this is a highlight special here. Mike Williams with the TD catch. It's a beauty. He's got 8 on the season, and the Orange are making it a contest. Well, Cameron Dantley just exhibited a very strong arm and a lot of guts standing in the face of a pass rush. Delivered TD pass, a 3-yarder back of the end zone to Mike Williams.
Incredible effort and great job of hanging in the pocket. He knew he was going to get hit, and a great job of coming down with the football by Mike Williams.
Jenkins backs up at the 7. But tripped up. Got his own man got him as much as anything. What about Mike Williams? Last week against Pittsburgh, this is a gorgeous finesse play. Brilliant catch. And then this one, back in the end zone.
Just the explosiveness to go up and get the football. You know, last week in a loss to Pittsburgh, he had a career high 8 catches. Today, 7 for 94, so he's knocking on the door of that career high. But he just did a great job of going up and accelerating and showing his strength coming down with the football.
Tell you what, if that had been a throwaway, you couldn't have blamed him, but he came out of nowhere. Real basic football. Straight up the middle with Mike Ford. Let's get more on Mike Williams with Sarah. We'll get back to Sarah in a moment. Mike Williams, big performance. 6'2" sophomore out of Buffalo, New York.
You know, the Bulls at halftime, Dave, they may have had that talk, and offensively, they think about running the football. Offensive coordinator Greg Gregory and head coach Jim Leavitt, they've run the football the entire second half.
Martin McGinn, referee today. Jim Leavitt talking over with his defensive unit. Hey, boys, what happened? See what Grothy and company do. One, fake the reverse, straight up the gut. Boy, Ford has really been a hammer today. Mike Mealy really stopped. Ford has been very strong. Very basic, too.
Yeah, this team has the ability to beat you with their speed on the edge, but when Ford goes north and south, he's a big load, Dave. He can pick him up and put him down in between the tackles.
27-10 South Florida. Grothy keeps. Boy, he just slips and slides through any kind of hole. Picks up about 8. Brought down by Mike Holmes.
The good thing about Grothy, when Matt Grothy runs the football and he's deciding where to go, he's always moving forward. He's always gliding in the hole and taking a peek if he wants to go right, cut left. But at the same time, Dave, he's getting yards, positive yards going down the field.
His wideouts do a pretty decent job blocking for him, even if they just get a piece or
right.
Just a shield block.
Yeah.
It takes a lot of punishment. A tough 2-yard run. Ran about 12, 15 yards to his right.
Well, do you think they've got the guys in the orange helmets close enough to the line of scrimmage where you think they may want to play fake and throw to one of the receivers?
The situation reeks of it.
Yeah. I know they want to come out and establish the run, and they've done a great job of that, going down and scoring in their first drive. But right now, you might want to take it away from, give it and take it away to Mike Ford and throw it to one of your big play guys in man coverage.
10 straight runs. First and 10. Grothy keeps, big yarded, 6-7 yards. Holmes again on the stop.
Then again, if you can't stop the run, you what might as well hate. Stay with it.
We're going to keep doing it till you stop it.
That's right.
Tell you what, they're running in a pretty good clip, too. In and out of the huddle. Whoa! That time bottled up. Joe Fields making the stop, and he was insistent on getting teams Jamar Taylor down on the ground. Hasn't been a whole bunch to celebrate defensively for Syracuse, but that was a good play by Joe Fields.
That was
58-yard interception return.
Right at the line of scrimmage, Joe Fields going to close in and make the tackle on Jamar Taylor. Taylor was upset at the end of this because Fields picks him up and puts him down, and you can see Taylor get up and say, hey, you didn't have to do that.
How about South Florida? 270 on the ground, 34 carries.
It's amazing.
Syracuse has netted 0 yards on the ground. Sprint out, Grothy downfield, got a man down there, caught, first down, and more. 22-yard line, he gets it to Torres Johnson, the 6'1 junior out of Cape Coral, Florida, gain of 23.
And that was great coverage, but what a throw and right catch. Terrific coverage by Mike Holmes. He has the corner the entire way. He's got the inside, but what an accurate throw by Matt Grothy, and great concentration on the catch.
First and 10, 23-yard line. Ford. Nice spin. Ooh, he got bounced hard by Nico Scott, number 28. Not before he picks up another 8 yards. We're checking again with Sarah.
Danville head coach Jim Leavitt for South Florida was looking for a way to motivate his team. So last night he introduced a shovel. He said that he wanted his guys to remember that they need to keep on digging and bury teams this season.
Nice imagery. Hey, kid, go out and buy a shovel tonight. Right before dinner, right before you come back. I need a shovel. You need what, coach?
You need a who? A shovel. You heard me. Yeah, they need the win today to make it a guarantee for their third straight bowl appearance. And the more wins they can get at the end of the season, the better bowl that South Florida will be at.
Ford again, real subtle. There he goes, runs into his own man, to the 5, to the 1-yard line. That's a good inside running by Mike Ford. Jake Flaherty finally brings it down, gain of 12. First and goal, South Florida.
Well, Dave, this is an attitude that the Bulls came out in the second half, and they said, we are going to run the football. I believe only one pass in the second half in this third quarter, and the reaction from Jim Leavitt, thinking they're getting into the end zone. Well, you didn't get in, but you're pretty darn close at the 1-yard line.
Yeah, what football coach doesn't like sluggo football? 20 carries, 101, and a touchdown. Here's Grothy, gonna give it to Ford, and his momentum is gonna get him in. Touchdown, South Florida. So Ford, boy, they brought out the hammer today. His second rushing touchdown. He's got a 100-yard game. Game in, it's 33-10.
Well, Ford would not be denied, and a good job at the line of scrimmage by Lee Williams for the Cuse. They did a good job of trying to win that battle at the line of scrimmage. You see Perkins there as well. But Ford would not be denied.
Ford is built and he's tough.
Yeah, I heard that somewhere, partner.
Alvarado. Perfect day for Delbert. And it's 34-10, South Florida. Mike Ford having a day. They have had a pantheon of brilliant, magnificent running backs. There's the best ever on your left. Jim Brown, Larry Zonka, here today, Ernie Davis.
Wow.
Floyd Little.
Floyd. Tim Green on the left.
Great player. Tell you what. South Florida having a good day on the ground. Ford, 6 carries for 40 yards in that drive. A 10-play drive that featured 9 runs. He had 6.
Yeah, 1 pass on the drive.
Johnson caught that pass. High kick to Suter, 10-yard line. Max has got an alley. And he's tripped up. Penalty flag. They got tripped up. Jerome Murphy making the tackle. Jerome Murphy.
Legal block. below the waist on the kicking team, number two. 15-yard penalty be added on to the end of the run. First down.
Dylan Douglas, the guilty party on that infraction. Told you by Gerard McGinn. Don't forget, we'll check out the Liberty Mutual Coach of the Year. Here's how to vote for your favorite coach.
The Liberty Mutual Coach of the Year Award is given to the college football coach in each division who delivers results while demonstrating exceptional responsibility and integrity both on and off the field. Go to coachoftheyear.com and vote for the coach you think deserves to win in 2007.
Back here at Syracuse, 34-10. Other good candidates for Coach of the Year. Max Suter's in the backfield. Moffitt tried to call a timeout. They give it to him. Ooh, I don't know. I tell you, Gerard McGinn said he had it. Here's a referee. Moffitt's the middle linebacker.
South Florida.
Danley was almost simultaneous as he called timeout, and Danley took the snap and went back.
Yeah, Wally Burnham, the defensive coordinator, kind of asking, well, I don't know if I wanted that one or not. But they did grant him the timeout. Gerard McGinn was looking right at him. Moffitt's right in the middle of your screen. He's calling for timeout.
Yeah, he got it. No problem. You got the timeout sign up before the ball was snapped. Speaking of Coach of the Year, who's your candidate for Big East Coach of the Year? Here's Ken Jimmy's Jims.
Well, we've got a couple of them. You can't deny Randy Etzel at UConn. You know, what a record, a surprise story in the Big East. And then Brian Kelly coming from nowhere and bringing Cincinnati to prominence. And then Rich Rodriguez, you know, when you're expected to have a good team and challenge for the national title, you know, it's one thing, but to live up to those expectations, you only lose one game on the road to these Bulls, and they really turn the football over in that game. So those are my three candidates from the Big East.
First down play for the Orange. Oh, knocked down by Bruce Bonpremier. Tried to gun it in there. Bruce got to have a sore right hand, but he broke up the play. Maybe a sore left hand. Coming up later on this afternoon in the Big East Conference, the first place team in the Big East, the Connecticut Huskies. 19 picks. Cincinnati has won all three meetings in that series.
And both of these teams love to take it away, and Connecticut has done a good job of really protecting the football. And can they make enough plays on the road against Cincinnati?
You mentioned good quarterback, couple of good running backs, whole line's performing well. So offensively, they can do some things. Dantley, 12 of 19, a pick and a touchdown, 199 yards. Blitz coming, he hangs, fires, throws, no. Broken up far side, Trey Williams for 21. How about Trey Williams, All-American candidate, senior from Plant City, Florida. He is wonderful. First team All-Big East performer a year ago.
Well, this is one of the matchups we talked about on the edge. Trey Williams against Mike Williams. Good job on breaking the football. He was in better position to catch it than Williams was, or the Williams in orange.
73-yard INT return last week for Trey. Gave South Florida 7-0 lead. He's got four picks on the season, 14 in his career, and he's returned two for touchdowns. Blitz coming. Dantley. Wow, clutching on a Chiara. And then play is dead. They're going to say
he was on the ground.
He was on the ground, absolutely. So they lose 2 yards on the play.
One more day of the week, and that would have been a good play.
That's right. It would have been a live play, no doubt about it.
That's right. Adrian Dantley trying to throw the screen again. It was successful in the last series, but you can tell, hand on the ground, and Dantley just did a good job of trying to find his fullback.
Well, here's a look at the punter for the Orange. Rob Long's got a 73-yarder to his credit today. Hangs on up. Fair catch signaled. 17-yard line by Marcus Edwards. 32 yards on that punt. And South Florida have a good starting position. We look at the Polaris out-of-town scoreboard. How go you Badgers, 23-7 over Michigan. Clemson 34-10, Penn State.
Struggling a little bit.
Hey, Temple
on the road.
Hanging in. They threw Temple out of this league. Missouri leading. They got a good
quarterback.
Hey, Sylvester Krum has turned it around. How big a win can that be after what happened to him when he had the Alabama job and at the last second he took it away. He's a proud son of Alabama, one of Bear Bryant's favorite players. Good for him, yeah, sticking it to Alabama.
Got a freshman quarterback in Wesley Carroll out of St. Thomas Aquinas that I was able to help out the last couple of years.
That's a huge story. Sylvester Croom leading Alabama. That's at Mississippi State. That is huge. Man. South Florida. Well, they must be jumping for joy in Starkville, Mississippi. Second down at 6. Worthy all day. Deep middle. Man, wide open. 40. 50. And at the first down to Jamar Taylor, who snuck out of the backfield. Joe Fields with the tackle. That's a 34-yard pickup.
Well, Dave, when we talked to offensive coordinator Greg Gregory last week, he said Matt Grothy's best throw is that bending route, that seam route down the middle. Well, that one was a dime to Jamar Taylor, wide open down the middle of the field. You can see a frustrated Nick Chestnut throw him down to the ground, but another big play by Matt Grothy in this offense.
Two tight ends, two wides. Up the middle, Ford rambling again for 8. Boy, does that kid run hard. Flaherty took a big piece of the punishment there. Jim Leavitt played some sluggo football. They have put up some big numbers on the ground. And for Ford, 23 carries, 123 yards.
You got to credit guys like Mark Dial, Dave, guys that have been hurt in this offensive line coming back into the game and providing lanes to run through.
Second and short, Ford. Well, he met the posse in the hole that time. The play was there. Yeah. South Florida on the ground, John, 39 for 304.
It's impressive what they've been able to do with this offense. Mike Ford, 124 yards, 2 touchdowns on 24 touches. Done a great job in running the football and carrying the load on the ground.
So that's, I believe, that yes, that is. That's the most they've given up on the ground this year. Check that. Illinois went for 378. Beg your pardon. 378 Illinois, Washington 302. But it's the most since 228 Rutgers a few weeks ago when we were here. He's going to have a big smile on his face as he sleeps on the plane ride home the way he is rolling. A reminder, check us out next week. Noon Eastern, Pittsburgh Panthers travel to New Jersey to take on the Rutgers Scarlet Knights. Check the local listings for the game in your area. We look forward to seeing Greg Schiano and the crew. We have not been to Rutgers. Can you believe it, this package?
No.
I've been there 2 years. See some good ones. Ray Rice, who leads the nation in carries, leading rusher in the Big East. LeSean McCoy right behind him. He had a nice bounce back last week after we'd seen him a couple of weeks ago with that just horrific fumble at the goal line that would have gotten the game into overtime.
Yeah, you're right. He had a terrific bounce back day. And Ray Rice, you know, when you think of Rutgers, you think of Ray Rice. You know, that's the guy that does it for them offensively. And no matter who's playing quarterback, he's still going to be the feature. And the guy down for South Florida is Mark Dial again.
Tell you what, he has gutted it out. It's
yes,
the second time we've had a play stoppage for him. The bad news is that he's lying, he's not moving. That's the real bad news. Hopefully he's just catching a blow.
There he goes.
Good.
All right.
That's good news. Big East standings. I didn't even think people in the Nutmeg State could have predicted Connecticut would be at this date on November 10, would be in first place in the Big East Conference by game over West Virginia.
Yeah, and we had just featured the Pittsburgh-Rutgers game next week, and that's a huge game within the conference in terms of bowl games and being eligible. Pittsburgh at 4-5, needing a couple more victories, and Rutgers trying to go somewhere that they haven't been. Last year, very successful, but trying to build back on that year.
Big East has 7 bowl tie-ins, and farther up the ladder you go, more prestige and more cha-ching,
yeah,
that you'll get.
That's right.
Mark Dial, Biggie's tie-ins. Gator's son, Meineke, Texas, Papa John's, and International. Well, that's up in Toronto.
Up in T.O., yeah.
The Rogers Center, good building up there. Good news is the big fella, Mark Dial, going to be able to get up.
Yeah, he's in a lot of hurt right now because he's been playing the majority of this football game banged up. Have to move Samson
Jenis
to the left guard.
6'1", 308.
Kick out Nick Capona, the backup center, out to left tackle. Or is that Ryan Schmidt? Ryan Schmidt will be in the game at left tackle.
And they move Schmidty over.
Yeah.
Second and four at the 27. Play action. Grothy. Oh, it's a pump and go. Nah, it wasn't there. Grothy's got some speed. Gets out of bounds, no harm. Boy, how about that? Nice gliding speed. And he gets out of a hot pursuit of Syracuse Brandon Gilbo. 5 yards in the pickup.
He's amazing at getting out of trouble and just being able to reverse his field and have a feel for where the pressure's coming from. And we talked about this in the meetings yesterday. Grothy has a knack for getting to the sideline before anybody can get a hand on him. And I don't know if he's that much faster than everybody else, but he just does a great job of getting to the sideline, and that graphic really speaks for itself.
Third and one, 23-yard line. Grothy will take it himself. He's got the first down. He's folded in behind the left guard. Another first down. Clock at 3:28. Boy, it was just, what, 4 years ago, John, we were up here. Walter Reyes was putting up all kinds of rushing numbers.
Yes, he was.
It was a tough ticket. They were drawn pretty well here at Syracuse. But boy, things have turned around the other way. Amazing how cyclical some of the things in college sports can be.
Well, you think about South Florida probably 4 years ago in the packed house they had on a night game with West Virginia coming in and us being there last week with 57,000.
Mm-hmm. Who knew 11 years ago, right?
Yeah.
Until the tight end. Board brought down by the linebacker. It's Flaherty along with Lee Williams. 45 and 55 respectively.
Well, the Bulls just chewing up some clock. They've done a nice job coming out in the second half, and I bet the drum beat at halftime was run the football, because they've done that ever since the third quarter started. They've done a great job of just chewing clock and chewing up yards.
Drive started back on the 18-yard line. Grothy, time complete. Got Johnson inside the 10 to the 8. First and goal, South Florida. Finally brought down by Dwayne Davis.
Nice timing route, and the ear hole right by the middle linebacker, Jake Flaherty. This good timing, hits his fifth step. Grothy catch and throw, and the linebacker can't adjust to the ball. Good timing in the pass offense by Matt Grothy.
Well, they are putting one of these boa constrictor squeezes on Syracuse. 11th play, drive started on the 18. Ford stymied, slowed up in there by Nick Santiago, number 95.
They've done it running the football, Dave, and it's no secret what the talk was at halftime. And you can see in the play selection in the second half, South Florida, 25 rushes and only 3 passes. And really, Syracuse hasn't had the ball. 7 plays, they put some points on the board, but they haven't had the football in the second half.
3:21 on the ground to nil for Syracuse. Wide side of the field to Grothy's left. The second and goal at the 9. They bring some people. Quick pop, touchdown, Johnson. Beat the blitz like it wasn't even there. Touchdown, Torres Johnson. 40-10, South Florida. Jangle of keys and the stirring you hear, people exiting the carrier dome.
That was just a great throw, and it beats the linebacker again. You can see Flaherty, 45, never turns his head to the quarterback. If he does, it'll bring him into the throwing lane. He doesn't, and it provides the throwing lane for Johnson on the reception.
Ruthie's thrown for 2. run for one. Extra point. Alvarado just, oh, by the way, is it right through the uprights, 41-10.
At some point defensively, you have to turn and find the football. And if Jake Flaherty does this on this play, he's at linebacker right here, and he's going to take a drop. All you run here is a slant. If he turns his head towards the throwing lane, it'll take him to the football. But Jake Flaherty only looks at the receiver, and the ball beats him to the spot. And it's an easy touchdown for South Florida.
Johnson was really open. Carothy's second TD pass today. Johnson, it's his third. And for Matt, on the season, gives him 11.
Make something happen. Let's go. Now slide over.
Tell you what, that club, that defensive unit, was on the field
long for a time. Oh. Only four passes, I believe, and 25 runs.
Unreal.
There's and the scoring
is,
drive.
That is putting some hammer on.
407, Dave. 12 plays, 82 yards. That hammer's getting heavy.
It is. Alvarado. Suter gonna run up and get it up to 13. Gets popped in the neck as he crossed the 32-yard line. 17 yards on the return. Sam Miller makes the return. Take a look at our Big East leaders, brought to you by the Chevy Silverado. How about this kid, George Selby? He got off to a terrific start. He just embarrassed the old line for Syracuse in that first series, and that's what he's done on the season. He's been outstanding.
He just dominated the line of scrimmage on the edge with his speed, and he's got strength to go with it.
That is some combo. 41-10 with 1:35 to go on the third. Bubble screen, Williams. About five. McKenzie brings him down. Look at the talents of George Selby.
No matter who they put out there in blue and orange, they could not contain or could not block. George Selby came down the line of scrimmage, made a lot of plays in the orange backfield. That's what he's known for. Tackles for loss. Today he had three of those, one sack, and he leads the nation in both categories.
NCAA record for tackles for loss, 32.
Hey, get it.
Fiametta on a counter. Three. John, we talk about it all the time. I think there's a lot of differentiation between these two ball clubs, but the biggest thing is Florida speed, baby. Florida speed.
And you can tell it, you know, in the line, you know, the defensive line play, not only on the skill receivers, but, you know, in that interior, that defensive line, they've got some big kids that can run.
Hey, Cray and those guys are carrying close to three bills, and they're moving
around.
Doesn't
look like it.
Yeah. Third and short. One hop in completion, trying to get it to Taj Smith. Another three and out for the orange offense.
Yeah, and another pressure for Allen Gray. Came in with an injury, ankle and groin, and he's done a great job in the middle. If it hasn't been Selby on the outside, it's been Gray on the inside.
Number 94. Boy, defensive coordinators, they salivate when they say, hey, I only have to send four and I can drop everybody else?
Yeah.
Kidding?
Makes it a lot easier on the back end of that defense.
Long on the punt for the sixth time. He's done a nice job today. 22-yard line, fair catch by Marcus Edwards. 4-5 hang time on a 37-yard punt. A long day indeed for these orange. 10 seconds to go in the fourth. Building holds 49,262. They're expecting a crowd of about 34,000. As we approach the fourth quarter, there will be significantly fewer fans here in the ballpark.
We have Grant Gregory in at quarterback for the Bulls.
South Florida, last three possessions, they put touchdowns on the board. Oh, nice cut. About a 6-yard pickup. Mosey Planchier So put the third quarter in the books as South Florida put up 13 in the second, 21 in the third, and it's 41-10 as we head to the final 15 minutes, and we're going to get to know George Selby. For your chance. Welcome back, everybody. Big East Football Conference game of the week. We're in Syracuse. It's been all South Florida. 7 points in the first quarter, 13 in the second, 21 in the third, and now Grant Gregory, a junior from Athens, Ohio. He's the son of the offensive coordinator. We'll get a chance to run this South Florida offense. He's a transfer from Indiana. A lot has gone right for South Florida. There's a look at Grant, his dad, Greg, a longtime coach, the offensive coordinator. Greg was at Army for a long time, from 1982 to 1997. Then went to Missouri Southern State, Richmond, Ohio, now in his third year at South Florida. Growth these days done, 181 yards passing, two touchdowns and a pick. He rushed 14 for 73 and a touchdown. And a catch made by A.J. Love, and that's going to move the sticks. First down, South Florida. Before this drive started, South Florida had accumulated 507 yards total offense. Syracuse 205. That was through three quarters.
It was a nice throw by Grant Gregory on the slant there. South Florida hasn't thrown the football much in the second half, but a good delivery there by the junior.
Run it inside. Linebacker number 46, Parker Canty, makes a nice play on Plancher.
This is far side.
Long day here for the Orange. And Larry Zonka stopped by for a hello. Pro football Hall of Famer.
Well, the Orange needed the Zonk today, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Running that football.
Did he catch it?
I think he did. That was a heck of a catch.
I'd say from the back, I said it. The back judge said he was adamant. He said it hit the ground. Back judge Keith Washington.
Doris Johnson, the ball just a little outside and behind. See if that ball hits the ground. Yes, it does. Another look. Side angle.
Side judge Patrick Garvey makes the call.
Yeah.
That's a good one. He had a great angle on it.
Good sell job, though, by Torres.
Darn
Johnson.
Right. Third and 10. Deep middle man there. Caught. First down and more. A.J. Love to the 26. First down, South Florida. Well, that's a coach's son's throw, huh?
That is.
35 yards.
Right down the middle. No middle safety, and he blows by Mike Milley, the underneath coverage, and over the top. Joe Fields can't come off the hash and get there soon enough. Good job by Grant Gregory throwing a catchable ball to A.J. Love. Only his second catch of the season. That one, a big one.
A.J.'s a freshman from Bradenton. Second catch. One inside. Plancher's got it. About a yard, 2 yards. Anthony Perkins makes a psycho play down there to make the stop. No movie fans out there? I guess not.
Yeah, no. I got you. I was just looking at my notes. I mentally nodded to you.
Okay. I'm just making sure everybody's paying attention now.
Everybody's still here.
Okay. Hello? Hello? Hello?
I was just paying attention to Matt Grothy. I was trying to get his numbers, and the boys put them up for me. Thanks, guys.
Including the first tackle, that's A.J. Love.
Still coming in loud and clear. Ooh, a couple late flags.
Yeah. Frustration level. You know that bad boy's over the top, and I think Nico Scott, I think he was the one that missed the initial. What can he say?
Matt Grothy having a heck of a day throwing and running, and really the running game in the second half did the job for the Bulls. They just shut the door on the Orange, and that was it. And Salvi on the other side of the ball, those guys can laugh about
dead
it.
Dead ball, personal foul on the offense, number 65, late hit. 15-yard penalty from the end of the run, third down.
It's Brian Schmidt getting chippy.
Yeah, I was just going to say, the last couple series, a lot of John going on between offensive line in white jerseys and defensive line in blue jerseys. That happens all the time.
Jim Leavitt. Does any come, well, he and Greg Shannon, I'd like to see them run a, 40 because he comes out in pregame and he sprints. As he comes out of the locker room, he sprints to the 50. And when we were here about 3-4 weeks ago, I thought Greg Shannon was going to kill two Jersey State troopers because somebody said, ready, said, go. And boy, he's sprinting out to the 50-yard line, and those troopers are barely hanging with him. Samuels gets another touch. He got some good blocking. Inside the 30 to the 28, Mike Mealy making the stop.
You're getting to see a little bit of a different offense with the backup quarterback Grant Gregory, and just a little bit of, instead of running quarterback, you're getting a little runs by throwing the football out, easy pitch and catches to the running backs.
So Alvarado has been good. He's been good from 42 and 33. Now from 46 on an angle. Anthony Severino, the holder. Derek Setzer is the snapper. 46 yards. Blocked. Goes right back to Severino. Third time he's been blocked this season. Nico Scott got it. Think about that. Anytime you get those long ones, boy, they got to get out a little bit low. And you bet if you can get in there quickly with some of your big people or a quick guy, you got a chance to make a play, and they did. Well, there has not been a lot to cheer about for the Orange, and they at least get a stop there, keep the Bulls off the board. 41-10. We're talking about Jim Leavitt. He's as effervescent and explosive a guy, and here he comes, Jim Leavitt. He's ready for some football. He's the head coach of the South Florida Bulls. Here he comes.
I think I got Leavitt over Shiano. I don't know.
Good look at the Hall of Languages here at Syracuse University. We're in the fourth quarter, 11:36 to go. Inside the Carrier Dome. Don't need too many different languages to explain what's happening here. 41-10. South Florida. Ty Smith draws a crowd. 8 yards on the pickup. Some of the starters still in there. Mike Jenkins, Louis Gachette. Ty Smith trying to extricate himself. He does.
Looks like he may have hurt himself on that pitch pass on the outside.
LeVar Lobdell comes into the game. And we got an injury timeout. Smith's going to whip off the field. Last, as we were going to break in that last timeout, Joe Fields, safety for Syracuse, limped off the field.
Good look at Cameron Dantley, the junior out of Silver Springs, Maryland. Getting some last-minute instructions from offensive coordinator Brian White. Dantley, Dave, we talked about his arm strength. He's got a live arm, but he hadn't had a whole lot of opportunities to use it today.
Tough go, boy, I tell you. Second and two. Dantley, 15 to 24, one touchdown, 210 yards and a pick. Bring a blitz. Throws it behind Shara. Miscommunication there. We'll take a look at our game-changing performance brought to you by Pontiac. Bad sign from the get-go, John. The opening kickoff.
Yeah, Max Suter drops the football on the opening kickoff. The Bulls get it, and they go right down the field. Mike Ford goes in from one, and that set up the entire football game for the Bulls. They went on to roll from that point with 10:46 left to go in this one. 41-10, South Florida.
Florida had a 7-0 lead after 1:20 to 3 at the half. They put up 21 points in the third. Orange 1 of 7 on third today. 7 in the block in the box there for South Florida. They're bringing a lot of folks.
They may end up calling this on the quarterback.
Prior to snap, false start on the offense. Number 59, 5-yard penalty remains. third down.
Well, I got some fast guys in the D line. George yeah. Selvey. And he influenced Carroll Madison.
That'll get you out of your three-point stance in a hurry.
Jared Bowie, he also. A lot of quicks on that D-line. This win's going to guarantee the Bulls third consecutive season. They bowl terrific. Rush four, drop everybody else. Bantley downfield overthrows the intended receiver, Rice Moss. Covered by Allen and Trey Williams.
Yeah, it was a good job by Allen and Williams. The bracket coverage on Rice Moss, the senior out of North Bethesda, Maryland. This South Florida team, offensively, defensively, and special teams, no shortage, Dave, on speed.
Speed, speed, and speed. Seventh punt. Long gets into it. Fair catch made, 19-yard line by Marcus Edwards, 38 yards on the punt. It's been all South Florida. Bulls lead at 41-10. Man number 26, Mike Ford, was brilliant today, pounding his way through the Syracuse offense. Here's Samuel, late flag coming in. That's the play he went 75 yards on to set up a field goal. That was back in the second quarter, made it 10-0, South Florida.
Holding on the offense, number 61, 10-yard penalty from the previous line of scrimmage. Replay, first down.
Zach Herman, the right guard, called for the penalty. 10:09 to go. Referee is Gerard McGinn. There's Zach. Game summary. How about Grothy? His day's done through three quarters, John. 254 total yards. Three total TDs, one pick. 14 points off of three Syracuse turnovers.
Yeah, Grothy had more total yards than the entire Syracuse offense. And Dantley had a pretty good day for the Orange. 15-26. Did a nice job of trying to get something started or ignited for the Orange offense.
The Orange offense has netted just 3 yards on the ground. Plancher. Brought down by Parker Canton. We had a good conversation with Rich Rodriguez earlier, the head coach of West Virginia. Mountaineers coming off their Thursday win against Louisville, 38-35. They don't tee it up again until next Saturday. They go to Cincinnati. Then on the 24th, they're home for Connecticut. That essentially could be for the Big East championship,
right?
Depending on what happens today, Connecticut at Cincinnati, that'll be a tough go. Keep the play alive. Penalty flag. And one hop, that's going to be an incompletion. As he got it upfield to E.J. Love, the intended receiver. Mike Holmes covering for Syracuse. Another hold. Double figure penalties for the South Florida Bulls when they had this 3-game losing streak. Between turnovers and penalties, John, big part of the story.
On the offense, number 70. Penalties declined, third down.
Jared Carnes called penalties. 14 penalties today. Wow.
Yeah, that's 34 penalties in the last three games.
Let's look at the Big East standings. Connecticut taking on Cincinnati within the hour.
And, Dave, that's a big reason why, you know, you lose three in a row to teams that are as good as you talent-wise. You turn it over and you have yourself a lot of penalties, you're going to lose those tight ball games.
That's right. Quarterback draw, Gregory. Ooh, what a lick. That was a real standout. Young man staying on his feet. How about that? Picked up about 11 yards.
Well, he had a bloody nose.
Oh, man, he teed him up. Oh, baby, he might have broken his face mask. Oh, my goodness, left eye, orbital bone. Man, he is, wow, he looks like one of those wrestling magazine. Wow. Well, that's what happens when you run straight up. And that's his dad, the offensive coordinator, Greg. And, boy, Grant, man, enough watching any of your guys take a lick, but when it's your son, Bridget knows he took him. Big shot. I think he'll get down a little bit quicker next time he gets into traffic.
Absolutely.
Alvarado to punt. Just the third punt coming up. Cut me, Mick. Cut me.
On a snap. False start. On the offense, number 93. 5-yard penalty remains. Fourth down.
Wow. He took a pop.
Yeah, it didn't look good from the start. Grant Gregory on the quarterback draw, loaded his shoulder right there, and his shoulder pad got in right underneath his helmet and his chin strap, and it doesn't look good for Grant on the sidelines. Doesn't look like he's in a whole lot of pain, but
need a little more forward lean, my man.
Yeah.
Oh, Alvarado nukes it. All the way back to the 24-yard line. Here's Ryan Howard. He gets taken down. 4-7 hang time on a punt that goes 61 yards, 13 yards on the return. Boy, Grant Gregory. Man, look at that cut. Oh, my goodness.
Personal foul. Face mask on South Florida, number 40. 15-yard penalty will be added on to the end of the run. First down.
About a minute and a half ago, I said there were 14 penalties. I think since then they picked up another five. Certainly feels that way. We'll take a break. 8:22 to go, 41-10. Jim Leavitt, South Florida Bulls. Well, we could use the fight doctor, Ferdy Pacheco, because I think...
And Mom may be leaning over the side, and
I think stitches are in order.
Yeah, I could have used Carlton Mitchell's mom, Angela. She's the cut man for pro boxer Antonio Tarver.
How about that? Right? Yeah. Should have been right on time. Sheeran with the catch. Now, how great is that? Your mom's a cut man.
That's how tough Carlton Mitchell must be.
Yeah, you got that right.
Get back in there. You got 30 seconds with a cold iron on it, right?
Hey, my mom can take your mom. Yeah, I think so. Holy geez.
No argument there.
But a rushing yard. I've never seen a disparity like this. 339 for South Florida to 3 for Syracuse. What a timeout with 7:39 to go. Second and 7 at the 44. Take a look at our Liberty Mutual play of the game.
Yeah.
Fine effort by Mike Williams.
Mike Williams really did a good job. The ball looked like it was going to be thrown in the back of the end zone out of play. But Mike Williams climbs the ladder. He gets the touchdown. His seventh straight game that he's had a touchdown, and that's a school record. 8 catches for 99 yards. Last week, he had a terrific game as well. He had 8 catches against the Panthers.
Let's get more on Mike Williams from Syracuse.
Guys, we're looking at the good hands and the good hops. Mike Williams was actually considering accepting a basketball scholarship before he came to Syracuse. So Greg Robinson said that he definitely is going to be talking to Coach Boeheim about it. And he said if he takes care of his business academically, then maybe we might see Mike Williams playing some hoops this winter.
About to get your breakdown on the Syracuse basketball team in the next few minutes. There's a long fly pattern down the sidelines. Nothing doing there. But he did look like a fine rebounder on that TD catch.
Yeah, he did. He went up and got the football and took it away.
Well, this is clearly not fun for any competitor to come out with your doors blown in at home. 575 total yards, South Florida, 217 for Syracuse. Third down play. Time goes short. Bob Dell, the catch. First down to the 32. Moffitt and Montpremier. And all the starters still in there for South Florida. Picks up 12.
Well, and Danley's had time to throw the football. He's been on target. He's done a nice job of showing off that big-time arm he has. Good pass there over the middle to Lobdell.
clock runs. 7:15 to go in the fourth. Bulls rush four. They'll run it. And yeah, line of scrimmage at best. Hogue with the carries. We take a look at our Keystone Light. Always smooth moment. He's our winner.
Well,
oh, man,
I like the graphic. Always smooth moment, but I don't know how smooth that is. He's doing his best, though. I'll tell you what.
He's having fun, the Syracuse band. They're undefeated today.
Yeah, they've done a great job.
No pattern. Lockdell. Looks like it's picked off. That was. He had inside position. Jerome Murphy, a sophomore from Elizabeth, New Jersey, with the INT.
Boy, Dave, that was textbook. Play the inside. Jerome Murphy located the football, went up at its highest point and took it away. This is just how you draw it up. If you're a defensive player, you see Cameron Dantley pump to the field, goes to the short side on the go route, but just great position by Jerome Murphy. Watch him go up, get the football, take it away from LeVar Lobdell.
Well timed. Fourth turnover today by Syracuse. 6:23 to go. And Anthony Severino is in. Remember Gregory got a cut in the face his last time in, so Severino's going to quarterback with the South Florida Bulls. Severino, 6'2", senior quarterback out of Jesuit High School in Tampa, Florida. Just some more of Ken Jemmy's gems. What do they have here, Jim?
Well, Big East Player of the Year candidates, and you have to go with Pat White, Ray Rice, and Brian Braum. They've all had terrific seasons for their respective clubs, and Pat White, what a performance he put on two nights ago with that big run to win the football game for the Mountaineers at home when it didn't look good. And Ray Rice, he's just been the workhorse for Greg Schiano and Rutgers the past couple of seasons, and Brian Braum, you know, they do a little bit better job defensively, they'd be in the hunt for the title as well, because offensively, nobody's been close to him throwing the football.
They did a very good job, Louisville, the other night coming from behind. I think they were what, down
17 at one point. Braum brought him back through the air, and they did a good job of putting themselves in position to win that game.
Tell you what, next year, pro level, or say maybe not necessarily next year, but eventually when he gets his feet wet in the pros, I mean, he's a ready-made guy. Boy, you get him on a good old line,
plug
receivers.
Plug him into the right system and the right team.
He's going to be terrific. I remember hearing a lot of reports he could have been among the top eight or nine picks last year.
Yeah. And you know, in saying that for Louisville as well, you lose a kid like that, but you plug in a Hunter Cantwell next year for a team that maybe tackles a little bit better. You never know what they could have.
Well, I would think that Steve Cragthorpe and his crew would put a very extraordinarily high premium on. Hey, boys, get some tacklers in here.
Yeah. You know, they may have put a little bit too much on the kid's shoulders that they had coming back defensively.
Move some offensive guys to the secondary. Not the same as having guys who played 4 years of high school ball as secondary people. I suppose you put an offensive guy back there. I mean, certain mentality, technique, ability, want to, a little bit different. Alvarado's kick. Howard, return left. So the punt. 42 yards, 7 yards on the return. George Selby, let's get to know him just a little bit better.
Hey, what up? I'm George Selby, sophomore defensive end from the University of South Florida. Well, I'm very superstitious, you know. I wear the same cleats that I wear in practice for the last 8 games, and I've been wearing the same gloves that I wore in the first 8 games. And the gloves right now, they're kind of beat up, they're kind of tearing up right now, and they got a big hole, and I tape it every time I got tape over it. But you can, this tape's kind of withered out now, so I got to put some new tape on it. It was a weird thing trying to change the offensive defense, but I try to do the best I can. Now I'm leading the nation in sacks. My second quarterback is all good, but I compare it most to like eating a honey bun because that's my favorite food. I love honey bun. You know, when you get back on them, it's so sweet, you know, they're so soft, and it's the greatest feeling in the world, so.
That's a big one, too.
Have at it, partner.
That's one of those big bear claws.
Well, what an engaging young man. We got to speak with him.
It's great. Gotta have him. Syracuse just ripped off its longest run of the day. 10-yarder by Suter. Inside four to play. Emptying Carrier Dome. Dantley, far side. He's got Lobdell for first down. 37-yard line, first down Syracuse. Let's get more George Selby. Here's Sarah.
Dave, I liked his lighthearted look on sacking the quarterback, but Selby actually had a scary experience as a kid when he was playing with his cousin around a car. His cousin knocked it out of park, and it rolled back and pinned George Selby underneath the car. His mother, some relatives rushed over, were able to pull up the car, and his mother pulled him out, but she said it was a miracle. He was in the hospital for a week. Skull wasn't fractured, but they had to restructure his skin. It's a blessing he's here.
Boy, I'll say. Scary stuff. 3:38 to go. Bentley looking left all the way, and he's got Marcus up for first down. That's a completion. It takes it inside the 25, 24-yard line. 13 yards on the pickup.
Well, George Selby had himself a honey bun Saturday because he did a great job coming from the edge. No matter who they put on him, he was able to get to Cameron Dantley and cause some confusion in the backfield. You know, he's the leader, NCAA leader in tackles for loss and for sacks. He had three tackles for loss today, one sack on the afternoon. That's a football player on the edge.
First down play, 24-yard line. Suter, wow. Blown up immediately, nowhere to go. And that was Terrell McLean.
You know, looking at South Florida, you take a look at George Selby, sophomore. Take a look at Matt Grothy, sophomore.
Brother.
I mean, these guys, those are the two impact players on offense and defense, and those are the two leaders on those respective sides. And you add in Ben Moffitt, who's a senior defensively at linebacker. But those two guys are going to be around for Jim Leavitt for a long time.
Second and 11. Knocked down. Pretty much telegraphed going left side. Chris Robinson knocks it down. 2:35 to go, fourth quarter.
Well, they get off the three-game loss slide, and Grothy has himself an afternoon, and Jim Leavitt happy on that sideline, knowing that they're one step closer to getting to where they want to be at the end of the year, trying to salvage what they have left after that three-game slide.
They're taking a lot of time here. Oh boy. That pretty much sums it up. That pretty much sums it up for the Syracuse Orange this afternoon. Syracuse average.
All sides on the defense. Number 90, 5-yard penalty remains. Third down.
But that Syracuse on the ground today, 1.4 yards a touch. South Florida 6.3 per carry. So a third and six coming up, 2:35 to go, fourth quarter. 21 third quarter points. South Florida blew this one wide open. Dantley running. Oh, look at that Florida speed. Everybody on this ball club can run. That's Dante Spires, sophomore outside linebacker from Tampa's Plant High School.
Yeah.
It's just a totally different category. You watch any of the teams in the Southeast Conference, and in this conference, West Virginia always gets good Florida speed. Rutgers has Florida speed.
And that's why this team was able to knock off Auburn on the road. They were able to match up, maybe not so much size-wise, but speed-wise, they were every bit as fast.
Yeah, figure Saturday night, Auburn, Alabama, they thought they were getting, they thought they were just getting another W. South Florida played a whale of a bowl game. A win at Auburn. That is, they don't do that often. Especially in a non-conference game. 2:28 to go on a fourth and six. And that's going to be good for first down to the 11. Got it down to LeVar Lobdell. Lobdell making a couple of catches. He's a sophomore from Christian Brothers Academy right here in Syracuse. 11 yards on the pickup. And time now for a Verizon Wireless MVP of the game. Easy choice, right, John?
Wow, 28 carries, 134 yards, two touchdowns, season high in yards. He had a 4.8 average. Congratulations to Mike Ford.
In the middle. Well, that had a lot of velocity on it. Tried to feed it into Dan Sheeran, redshirt freshman wideout number 81. Ford was relentless today. So
he really
was. Line.
That offensive line, Dave, good point. Inside the 5 yard line, they were able to open up a big enough crease for Mike Ford to fit into and get over the goal line. And he's only a freshman out of Sarasota. Future looks pretty bright for the Bulls.
Abdel far side right. Sheeran comes near side left. Blitz, look out. A screen, that's not going to work. And Dantley paid a big price. Blasted down by Aaron, make that Terrell McClain again. McClain, we've called his name a couple times here. Two flags on the play. Long discussion by Gerard McGinn. His crew.
Ineligible receivers downfield on the offense. Number 60, 5 yard penalty from the previous line of scrimmage. Replay, third down.
.156. Orange with the ball, second and 10. Second and goal, actually, from the 15 yard line. Down by Louis Gichette. 13 yard pickup. Get it down to the 2 yard line.
That was a nice catch. Ball behind Dan. He just idled his body down to be able to make the catch and get inside the five, down inside scoring range for the Orange.
Sharon, a 6'3 redshirt freshman from Golden Bridge, New York. Now Florida calls a timeout. Today's ESPN Plus game has been brought to you by Keystone Light. It can't always be smooth, but your beer should be. Chevrolet Silverado with the best available highway fuel economy of any full-size pickup. Liberty Mutual Coach of the Year. Vote now at coachoftheyear.com. The all-new Ranger RZR. See it up close at your local Polaris Ranger dealer. Advance Auto Parts. We're ready in advance. Suzuki Automotive and the all-wheel drive SX4 crossover. And by American Century Investments. Mutual funds in an institutional investment since 1958. Big East football here from Syracuse in the Big Ten. Wisconsin, the Badgers, 37-21. Mississippi State holding off Alabama by five. Orange with a third and goal at the two. Quarterback draw, Dantley. No. Boy, he was indecisive, and that really cost him. That split second probably cost him at least a yard.
Yeah, there's that speed again, even by the interior defensive line, Dave, being able to shut down a hole that looked wide open. Dantley looked like he may have a chance to get in the end zone, but that South Florida Bulls defense, especially that defensive line and linebackers.
A lot of regulars are still in there.
Yeah, keep them out of the end zone.
There's a fourth and goal at the two. Suter's the deep back. Gonna throw it. Fade. Forget it. So with 27 seconds to go, South Florida is going to snap it one more time, and this will be done.
We have to congratulate the Bulls coming in here and doing a good job trying to get out of that three-game losing slide that they were on. Played some tight games, but just couldn't find a way to win them, and they come back and makes them bowl guaranteed for the third straight season and ends that three-game losing streak that Jim Leavitt was in a hurry to get rid of. And Matt Grothy had a terrific afternoon. The running attack of Mike Ford did a great job. The 1-2 punch offensively was too much for the Orange to handle.
Takes a knee. That will do it. A resounding win by the South Florida Bulls. Jim Leavitt, after the heartbreak of last week's loss at home to Cincinnati, got one of his no doubt about it specials here today. Great ground game, fine defensive play. Pretty much everything went right for Jim Leavitt and the South Florida Bulls. 41-10, the final score here at the Carrier Dome in Syracuse, New York. Back with more right after this. The South Florida Bulls, they say goodbye to a three-game losing streak. South Florida's never lost four in a row, and well, they did it big time today.
Yeah, they did it with Mike Ford, as you see there, and Matt Grothy did a great job of running this offense. Not only his running, but his throwing as well today, Dave.
He was strong, and it was an outstanding performance throughout the entire roster for the South Florida Bulls. And they come out and they do big damage here in Syracuse. We'll see you next week, everybody, for the Pittsburgh Rutgers game. Final score 41-10, South Florida over Syracuse. And join us next Saturday at noon Eastern. Pittsburgh travels to Rutgers. So for John Congemi and Sarah Kustak and our entire crew, I'm Dave Sims. Thanks for joining us, everybody. This has been a presentation of ESPN Plus, the worldwide leader in collegiate sports. So long, everybody, from Syracuse.